Good afternoon and welcome to Saluki Stadium in Carbondale, Illinois for another key Missouri Valley Conference matchup on this Halloween Saturday here in Carbondale. Brian Shawn, Lee Timmerman, Beth Houle with you as North Dakota State takes on Southern Illinois. LT, we've talked about the top-ranked offense in the Valley taking on the top-ranked defense in the Valley. We're going to find out which wins out here today.
Yeah, I think because of the numbers simply that the Salukis have been putting up, as we see Vra and everyone on the offensive side getting ready for NDSU, I think it's a game that really has the coaching staff nervous, not knowing quite how many three and outs you're going to get. And the Bison, if they don't get them, there's going to be a lot of points scored by the Salukis today. That's been what they have done all year long.
One of the major concerns for the North Dakota State defense is the defensive ends. Greg Menard, Brad Ambrosius, and Jared Tuska all banged up coming into this game. We may see a variety of different alignments at defensive end, and that includes Levi Jordheim and possibly even Pierre G. Tucker playing some snaps there.
Well, and Coach Entz even said, don't be surprised on first down if Nate Tangway goes from inside to outside, depending on the health of the guys like you're just looking at right there. So we'll see. Menard doesn't know if he's going to be in the starting lineup. Ambrosius banged up, number 97. He will be in the starting lineup. And what those defensive ends get accomplished today will be so important against the offense and the way the Salukis run that offense.
Beth Houle on the sidelines for us has a report. Beth?
Hey, guys, you know, you're talking about these defensive ends. It's obviously a concern for this Bison coaching staff today. I did just get word from defensive ends coach Jamar Kane saying that Greg Menard is a go. He had a good warm-up. They're looking to get him out there, but those reps are going to be limited for all of those defensive ends, which means that they really need this offense to play their game. They can't get wrapped up into that high-speed chase game that Southern Illinois likes to do. They have to slow it down. They have to play their football game. If they can control the clock, control the ball, and keep that Saluki offense off the field, the Bison will be just fine.
All right, thank you very much, Beth. So we will see Greg Menard today as the teams are out at midfield getting ready for the coin toss. And LT, Southern Illinois for Dale Lennon, we talked about this. This is not in his mantra. He'd much rather win a game 17-14, but frankly, what has been working on offense for them is this new up-tempo system, a new offensive coordinator calling the plays, and Nick Hill, and so far, so good.
Yeah, I know that Nick Hill and O'Brien are called co-offense coordinators, but Hill is the guy who's calling the plays. And if his name sounds familiar in Missouri Valley Conference football, it probably should, because a lot of the records that Iannotti is breaking or coming close to breaking are records that Nick Hill had here. So it is a high tempo, high thing. And the biggest thing, too, I think, if you look at Iannotti, is his passing percentage numbers. I mean, he's completing just a smidgen under 70% of his passes to go along with being the top rusher on the team as well.
Got to look at Mark Iannotti right there. Again, they talked about why his system has been so much improved this season, LT, and why he's playing so much better. And they said it really is the system and a big reason why he's flourishing, also leading the team in rushing this year.
Interesting thing about Iannotti, too, is I don't know if you recall this, but he's still a big guy, weighs 220 pounds, but he's lost. O'Brien said he's lost about 30 pounds. And so they took him off to try to get a little bit more speed. But he does get hit a lot. Most quarterbacks, even running quarterbacks, the coaches worry a little bit about, hey, we don't want our guy to run too much. That is not the case at SIU. Matt Entz, the defense coordinator for the Bison, said they don't care how many times he gets hit. They'll bring other guys in for a play or two, but that just tells you the approach and how important number 19 is to the offense, and that's who will have the ball when we start this thing.
Yeah, don't be surprised if you see Matt DeSomer and Matt McIntosh, two other quarterbacks. DeSomer's actually been moved to wide receiver, but he does take some snaps at quarterback, mainly for Wildcat purposes. So a very versatile attack, and we haven't even talked about Daquan Isom, who may be the best true freshman in the league.
You might not know it by looking at the flags on top of the goalpost, but the wind is blowing fairly hard today from the right to the left on your screen, so it'll affect punts more than anything else when the ball maybe gets above the crest of this nice stadium here in Carbondale.
We did anticipate some rain in the morning coming into the afternoon. It has not rained that much since early this morning, so that really has not been an issue. The turf not very wet. We walked on it earlier, LT, and things really in pretty good shape.
Yep. No, I don't think, I mean, unless they start slipping around, but I don't think that'll be an issue.
Well, the Bison deferred, so Southern Illinois will have the ball first. Already 53 explosive plays of 20 yards or more for Southern Illinois in the first seven games. Daquan Isom has it or takes it and lets it go out of bounds, and Southern Illinois will start from their own 25-yard line.
Yeah, speaking of explosive plays, not having that guy right there returning a kickoff is a good thing if you're NDSU, because it's not a matter of if, but they're just waiting for when he breaks one in terms of a special teams play as well.
Well, Daquan Isom, as you alluded to, LT, second in the FCS in all-purpose yards for any true freshman. So this is a guy that has getting a lot of reps in a lot of different spots. He did also catch a screen pass for an 80-yard touchdown last week against Youngstown State, and the Salukis overcame an 11-point deficit in the fourth quarter to pick up the victory against the Penguins. Iannotti will keep it on first down. Gains about four up to the 29.
A lot of motion, a lot of movement before the snap. That kind of jet look where the wide receiver goes across the face of Iannotti. It's a very familiar pattern in this offense.
No huddle, quickly back to work. Quick flare out to Lamprakis, and Lamprakis pushed out of bounds at about the 32-yard line. Will bring up a third and three. Lamprakis, a huge catch last week against Youngstown State in overtime to win that one.
Yeah, it was the third play of overtime where he caught the touchdown pass, and then YSU on a fourth and short in overtime threw a halfback pass of all things. That was kind of a strange end of that game last week.
And there is a flag as somebody moved early there on the Southern Illinois offensive line.
Well, when you're a hurry-up offense and you want to get as many plays as you can run as possible, it's one of the things that you do to slow yourself down is exactly that. A little pre-snap movement, five-yard penalty, third and long now.
So the Bison will make some changes on the defensive line here and try to hold Southern Illinois here on third and eight. The Salukis doing a good job in third down this season, right around 50%.
There you see Jordheim in there, I believe, at one of the defensive ends. Tucker as well.
Bison bringing pressure. Iannotti has time, and this one floated up, and it is intercepted by Jalen Allison. No, out of bounds. He was bobbling it and incomplete, but it certainly looked like Allison had it there for a moment.
Well, then Billy Reed thought he had it for a moment, too, and then neither of them did because Reed went over and ripped it out of Allison's hand. But that's a similar pass pattern, too. SIU's offense, they do a lot of things in a 50-50 ball in a one-on-one situation. That ball hung up in the wind there a little bit, too. Not the prettiest of passes.
So on for his first punt, Derek Mathewson, averaging right around 41 yards a kick. A senior from Vista, California. Mathewson hangs this one up. Eric Perkins calling for the fair catch at the 35-yard line, and he hauls it in, and the Bison will have it there for their first drive of the afternoon offensively.
Well, an outstanding start, helped by the penalty, obviously, but the Salukis with a three and out. That'll be an important thing to keep track of, I think, for NDSU today.
Here's a look at the Bison offense. Easton Stick making his second career start. The big boys up front finally getting healthy, led by Austin Kuhnert at center. They feel he's much closer to 100% than he was last week. Zach Vron, R.J. Erzendowski, the two standout wide receivers for the Bison. There's a look at Stick, 126 yards passing, 124 yards rushing last week in a victory at Indiana State.
Yeah, first 100-yard rusher for NDSU this year was Stick last week. That sounds weird, doesn't it?
Stick will keep it, has an open receiver, and that is Darius Shepherd. And he is taken down after a gain of eight up to the 42.
Well, Thompson not getting up. I would say he's getting up slowly, but Anthony Thompson watched the tackle here on the replay. Little pass, flared out. And I'm not sure why Thompson didn't get up on that. I thought he was holding his shoulder or something, unless when he was sliding along the turf, his elbow kind of grabbed and maybe pulled that out of the socket a bit. I don't know.
Thompson, a red shirt at UCLA in 2011, came over and transferred to SIU, originally from Montreal, and he does walk off under his own power.
Cornerback has been an issue for the Salukis so far this year. Their defense has given up a bunch of big plays, and a lot of them from the outside.
And here is a look at the SIU defense. We talked about the safeties. DJ Cameron making his 42nd straight start. Chase Allen, considered maybe the best linebacker on this SIU team, and Rayshon Golden, a senior, kind of anchors that defensive front. Starting lineup brought to you by Shields. Power game. King Frazier chugs ahead up to the 44, about 2 yards short of a first down.
Now Chase Allen, who is tied with Kenny James for most tackles, number five. You see him come up and make the play. He is one of the playmakers where the Bison coaches always try to identify who on this defense can hurt us. Well, there's three numbers on the field that NDSU feels are the top guys. Number 82, number 5, and number 31. Those are the three guys to make plays, and you just saw Allen from his inside linebacker spot make the play right there.
Third and short coming up for the Bison. Ground game, not much room, and I don't think that Frazier got there. He's about a yard short up to the 44. So the SIU defense comes up with a big stop, and they force a three and out as well.
Just trying to run really hard right up the gut, and no real push that time from the offensive line. So Frazier just didn't have any options. He tried to get what he could, and he is short. In fact, he lost, I think, about a yard on that play.
Player comes on late there for SIU on punt coverage.
That punt should sail pretty good once it gets up into the wind.
And LeCompte does sail this one into the end zone, and SIU will have it at their own 20-yard line. When we come back, we're scoreless, 12-17 to go on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Back in Carbondale, taking a look at your Shield starting lineup for the NDSU defense. Nick DeLuca, leading tackler in the middle. Again, Ambrosius and Menard both starting, and Chris Board and Trey Dempsey at your safeties today. First down run, again, not much room. Pickup of just one that time for Iannotti up to the 21. Here's a look at the SIU offense starting lineup, also brought to you by Shields. Iannotti, we talked about him. The left side of the line, a little bit sketchy. Reed Sealby getting his second start, a transfer from Iowa, and also Billy Reed, the leading receiver for this SIU team, number 17. Isom gets the carry, and Daquan Isom goes down after a gain of one. We'll bring up third and long once again.
So far, the running game's just not there for SIU. The quarterback run, Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. You see the read option. Isom takes it. He's the freshman who's just been outstanding so far. And Isom is a guy who has made big plays, so you obviously want to box him in, keep him in. He'll want to bounce it a little bit more to the outside. Bison keep him in, and there was good pursuit from the linebackers. Another third and long.
Pierre G. Tucker and Levi Jordheim. This one across the middle and complete. Open receiver is Billy Reed. On the coverage, Jalen Allison. He's got enough for a first down up to the 34.
Well, Iannotti knows for a fact that he's going to get man on that side because there was trips receivers to the near side, and the Salukis motioned to the trip receiver side. No doubles on the outside to his left.
Iannotti will keep again. And Pierre G. Tucker in on that stop. And this is a homecoming of sorts. Yeah, for Pierre G. Tucker.
DeLuca is also there to make a pretty good hit, too. There's the pass, the little slant across. Allison knows he doesn't have safety help deep, so he can't get beat deep. And remember the first pass play that went Allison's way was a pass that was deep. They tried to take the top of it off. It didn't work. Allison almost got the interception, but here he knows he has to not gamble without having the safety help over the top.
We do have an offensive lineman down.
I think that's Clark, center.
Yeah, it is. Garrett Clark, who is a senior from Jacksonville, Florida, making his 15th start. And he's not showing a lot of signs of movement right now. So, again, that will change up the offensive line once again for SIU. And from what I understand, LT, if another offensive lineman goes down, in this case, they'll move Sealby over, and they'll bring in David Meyerhoff to play guard.
To play guard, and, yeah, Sealby will play the center position. And it doesn't look, yeah, Clark's going to have to be looked at.
We'll take a timeout and be back.
Nope, they brought in Griffith.
Oh, did they?
Yeah.
There's a look at the injury that just happened to Garrett Clark, the starting center for SIU. It certainly does not look like he is going to be able to return based on the fact he was not able to put any weight on that foot, LT. Yeah,
the Salukis did not move Sealby, though. They brought Griffith in. He is now the backup center.
Iannotti will throw deep. Lamprakis goes up and gets the football on C.J. Smith, and SIU an explosive play down to the 41.
Well, they've had a bunch of those this year. A play of 20 yards or more is what is deemed an explosive play. Nodak Mutual Insurance, Smith just running with the receiver along the sideline. Pass a little bit to that back shoulder. The receiver sees it. The defender doesn't. First down.
Isom, no room. Bison completely swallow him up. Robbie Grimsley in there along with Nick DeLuca.
Well, you can see with the safety and a linebacker, the first two players there that deep into the play that obviously the Bison coaches were thinking run and calling run and going for it with your safety, strong safety, Grimsley in this case, coming down that far that fast.
Iannotti will keep it again, and Iannotti puts his shoulder down and picks up close to four, up to the 41. We'll bring up third and five.
I mean, that wasn't even a read. They're not reading anything. This is just a run, and a straight quarterback run. Get your big man moving. Again, he weighs 220 pounds. Now you got, what, about third and four or five? But a lot of designed straight quarterback runs in this offense.
Iannotti will once again work out of the shotgun. Bison showing some pressure there on the edge. Iannotti looking deep for his receiver, and that was some contact by C.J. Smith. It did look initially like the receiver broke off his route. That was Billy Reed before C.J. got hands on him.
And Coach Kleiman's trying to say, well, the ball was way over their head, trying to say it was an uncatchable thing. You couldn't make a play on it. Reed did a little stop-and-go route. The pass was over everyone's head, but there was no doubt that there was contact right where that flag is. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. You're looking at the top of your screen. Iannotti's pass, stop and go. Smith stops, gets a hand in there. So after a three and out on its first possession, SIU is doing what it has done a lot so far this year, and that is move the ball.
Five receivers in this set, including Adam Feeney there, the big tight end, 6'7", 260.
But you can see so far in the pass plays, it's nothing too complicated in the routes or anything that the Salukis are running.
And that is actually the wide receiver, Jimmy Jones, getting the carry. Got close to 2 yards up to the 19.
By no means do we watch film of every play of every game, but so far this year I haven't seen a lot of that out of Jones. He's come across the formation most of the time. That time he got the handoff, went back to his left.
Quick screen out to Lamprakis, and Lamprakis makes one man miss, still on his feet, and then the Bison stack him up after a gain of 2 yards up to the 17.
Kind of a little bubble look, hoping to get a block or two. DeLuca gets one arm around him to slow him down enough, and then here come the reinforcements.
So another third and five coming up here for SIU as they've moved into the Superior Inc. red zone. And you see DeSomer, Matt DeSomer, lining up at quarterback. He's a Wildcat.
Yeah, he doesn't throw it.
And he's got room. And DeSomer, nice open field tackle by Trey Dempsey. Maybe a gain of one.
Well, Dempsey hit him hard, but they... In terms of who's getting up the slowest, it's Dempsey that got the worst of this collision.
So that will bring in Austin Johnson, a 5'11 junior.
Oh, it's taken Dempsey a little more time to come off, so the officials are letting and allowing NDSU time to get the new player in. I think that's Wimbush who came in. Well, it's a special teams play anyway. But the kicker, Johnson, has been...
spotty.
Yeah, hot and cold. He made five of his first six kicks, and then after that, he's made, what, 5 of 10, I think? So it has not been good.
10 of 16 so far this season. Johnson, this one looks pretty good. And it is good.
Excellent foot going into the wind, too.
Yeah, Johnson boots it through from 32, and SIU is on the board. It's 3-0 on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Back at Saluki Stadium in Carbondale, Illinois, Southern Illinois leading 3-0. And 11 plays, 64 yards in just 4.5 minutes, capped off by the Johnson 31-yard field goal. So SIU able to get something going, at least on that drive. A couple of first downs, one aided by penalty.
Yeah, a couple of things through the pass, and then the ground game, you can't say it's been opened up yet, certainly by Saluki standards, but they were able to move the ball in order to grab the lead. Dempsey, by the way, the first we thought he just kind of got the wind knocked out of him, but we understand now that Trey's helmet's been taken away from him, so he won't go back in until they can further look at him just a little bit more. So we'll keep an eye on that. Beth's doing a good job in the Bison sidelines.
Again, safety there's been a bunch of different guys that have played there. We've seen mostly Robbie Grimsley and Trey so far here today. Short kickoff into the wind. Perkins had to take it at his own 25, and the Bison will have pretty good field position up to the 34.
The kick ended up holding up into that wind so long that no matter what the call was in terms of trying to run it back, Perkins really had no choice but just to take what he could get straight up the field.
Look at the Bison offense, three and out on their first possession. And Tim Polasek mentioning to us that they really want to try to get somebody going in the running game early and then ride the hot hand, but they really just have not had that number one running back emerge yet, LT.
Well, they think it could probably be Dunn, but you don't see too many snaps from Dunn yet because he's still coming back from his injury, and he's not 100%. But there you see King Frazier, the D-back alongside of Stick. I wouldn't be surprised to see Stick get a few more runs.
And Easton's going to run here, and he's got room. Easton Stick is off to the races. Inside the 30, the 20, Easton Stick inside the 10-yard line and down to the 5. And a big run for the redshirt freshman from Omaha.
Well, I think you could just sense that one coming. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. The defensive end crashes down and goes with the fake. You saw him get sucked all the way over to the nose on the fake to Frazier. The one little kick out, and Stick is wide open and has to get caught from behind. And just like that, the Bison are where they want to be, 5 yards away from a touchdown.
Boy, one of the longest runs the Bison have had from scrimmage certainly this year, 60 yards.
But the Salukis, again, have given up a lot of big plays on defense, so the Bison need to capitalize.
Two backs in the backfield. You see Chase Morlock. Inside handoff goes to Frazier, and King Frazier moves the pile ahead to about the 2 yard line.
Boy, Jackson came down and got a hold of Frazier and actually held on a little bit better than I thought he was going to. Jackson, number 13, got some help, but when Frazier got the ball, I thought at first, Brian, I thought he was taking it in, but. Jackson was able to stop his feet enough to make it only a gain of two. That play looked pretty good from the get-go to me.
Jackson, a sophomore from East St. Louis. The Bison again will operate out of the shotgun. Single back is Morlock. You're on second and goal. Easton's going to keep it again. Stick going to throw it to the end zone as he shovels it out to Erzendowski for a touchdown. Wow.
Well, the benefits of having a quarterback that obviously, you know, you need to honor the run. You flip it out kind of almost Tebow style. And Erzendowski was being covered. You see the quarterback break free. Well, what's the corner have to do? He's got to leave his man to try to tackle the quarterback still behind the line. A little flip out there and a touchdown. And that's the big play, obviously. The long run from Stick helped set it up. But I think it was important for the Bison to look good on offense. Well, you don't look any better than 7 points.
Extra point is added on the play there by Cam Peterson, who is now 25 of 25 at extra points this season. And the Creighton Prep connection strikes once again as Stick shovels it out to Erzendowski for the Bison's first touchdown.
Boy, as an offense, if you can put a defender in almost a no-win situation, which is what the corner was on that particular thing, you've got him beat. Because if he stays on Erzendowski, then Stick just carries the 3 yards in and runs it in himself. But he has to come off, and he off of Erzendowski, goes to the quarterback, and they flip it back in. Here should be a good look. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Touchdown.
Not the most conventional play, LT, but certainly effective.
And it goes as a touchdown pass, too.
And RJ catching a touchdown pass last week against Indiana State. Ended up being the go-ahead score for NDSU as they were able to knock off the Sycamores on the road. There's a look at Chris Kleiman in his second season as head coach. Has really had to get involved maybe a little bit more on both sides of the ball just to try to find different ways to get guys involved and be effective across the board on both offense and defense.
Well, the Bison with that big play to help get this touchdown. And I think NDSU coming into a game against the Salukis with the way SIU's had all that offense, I think, you know, obviously they'd be more comfortable with Wentz as the quarterback getting into a shootout, I think, which obviously NDSU still doesn't want.
Another Peterson farm seed kickoff, and LeCompte knocks this one out of the back of the end zone once again, and SIU will have it at the 25-yard line.
I've done that too already.
There's a look at Matt Entz, the defensive coordinator for the Bison. And he's put a variety of different players in different positions, LT, trying to find a combination that works in every situation. But what we have seen is when the Bison get in third and longs defensively, boy, they've been really good in that area.
Yeah, and then third and long is when we'll see most of the substitution patterns and the different guys in. Now it's the standard look with both Ambrosius and Menard at your defensive ends.
Iannotti's going to keep again, and the Bison once again ready for him. DeLuca was there and finished up by Robbie Grimsley.
Well, Nick makes his quick read. He stays on the quarterback, and it was not a clean fake. You saw the ball bobble a little bit out of Iannotti's hands, and of course you kind of forget about gaining yards when you need to gain control of the ball. So that play was kind of blown up a little bit from the get-go, I think, by the inability to keep it clean.
Isom gets the carry. He's taken down from behind by Nate Tangway, and that will bring up another third down here for SIU. About 5 yards to go. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
Tangway makes a real nice move to swim around his guy to the outside, then uses his feet to catch back up to Isom. Isom did not have a clear path. He was trying to go off tackle on the left side, but the point of impact was slowed down, so Tangway was able to make the adjustment and make the tackle.
Jimmy Jones in motion. Handoff goes to Isom, and Isom did not get there. Maybe a gain of one, and the Bison hold on third down. Ambrosius comes in to make the stop from his defensive end position.
Really stayed with the handoff a little bit longer. In fact, at first, I thought that Iannotti kept it, but then the handoff, Ambrosius there, you see him make the tackle. And the Bison with 2-3 and outs.
Second punt of the day coming up here for Derek Mathewson. Again, punting into the wind. That one hanging up. C.J. Smith at the 25 will call for the fair catch, and that's where the Bison will have it once again, leading 7-3 with 4:41 to go here in the first quarter. This game brought to you in high definition by Parents Lead. Have conversations with your children that matter. Providing tips and tools for conversations. Log on to parentslead.org for more information. So NDSU struck quickly on their last drive, going 65 yards in just three plays.
Different look with the fullback in there now.
Run to the outside and room to run as King Frazier is off to the races, and another big run inside SIU territory, pushed out of bounds by Ryan Neal at the 33.
Well, I thought Frazier did an outstanding job on this play to let things develop. This will be a perfect angle. You see him cut inside the one block there from Ilias, then plant his foot, get upfield, and now he'll just get as much as he can. Really nice read, nice way of kind of weaving through and reading where the blocks were. And, of course, when you're not touched as a runner until you're way downfield, that's obviously a big positive. So far, the Bison with their big plays coming on the ground.
And North Dakota State now on the move once again. Lance Dunn this time, got another big block, and now Dunn is loose inside the 20, churning the legs down to the 12-yard line, and the Bison have found something in particular on these runs to the outside, LT.
Well, I think it was Chase Morlock that got the block that you were talking about, Brian, the one that sprung the edge. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, check out, yep, there it is, the nice little cut, and then Dunn is able to get around the end and then head upfield. So, yeah, you make the one critical block. And then you see Bra trying to get something late downfield. If you can get another block or two out of your wideouts down their field, 15, 20 yards, those are the plays that end up into the end zone. But that one was pretty close. Well executed again, Morlock with the block.
Stick will run again to the short side of the field. Not room that time. He is stacked up at the line of scrimmage and driven back. Leading the charge that time was number 31, Kenny James for SIU, leading tackler.
But you could see there was a fake to Darius Anderson, but it wasn't one the word Anderson was ever, I think, in going to get the ball. And you know that by where the offensive line is going. They were slanting and working their way out toward the right, but this nothing ever developed.
Marquise Jackson also in another tackle. That's a loss of two.
Let's
Stick to throw. Easton Stick to the corner, looking for RJ Rzendowski, and it's intercepted in the end zone. Big play by Chris Adkins, the redshirt freshman, his first of the season.
Yeah, pass was not in a position where it was going to be catchable much for the offense. It was just too short. You have to give Rzendowski an opportunity to try to make a play or make an adjustment on it. And the only guy that needed to adjust was Adkins, the redshirt freshman, as you mentioned, Brian. He just had to stop, and it falls right into his lap.
The Bison turned it over twice last week. That is the second interception now this season for Stick. And gets the SIU defense off the field.
Bison ran a little cross, a little X with both of their tight ends. I thought one of those two guys were going to come open, but Stick tried to get it to Rzendowski.
Iannotti, back shoulder throw, and this one is caught. Nice catch with the hands there by Jimmy Jones. And he has a first down up to the 34, and SIU again on the move, going no huddle, going to try to get this one snapped quickly.
It's so hard in a one-on-one situation to try to control those back shoulder throws because you have to honor it deep downfield.
Jones again, the intended target on the quick drop. Pierre G. Tucker there to defend the pass, second and 10.
Just an interesting read from Iannotti, I think, trying to slam it into a place where it wasn't going to go. He just tried, almost, I don't know if it was a little stick route or whatever, but boy, Tucker was... I didn't think there was much of a chance at all that ball was going to be completed. It almost looked like Iannotti decided I'm going to throw it to him no matter what.
Iannotti to throw again, going to throw the fade pattern deep, and this one is batted away out of bounds. Officials threw their hats, which I think because the wide receiver had run out of bounds.
So he can't be the first one to touch it when it comes back in. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay again. Just another 50-50 ball downfield. And this time it's the pass stays over the top. Remember I said those wide back shoulders are so hard to defend? Because you, as a corner, you have to honor that play. And when it's thrown short into the back, you can't make the adjustment on it as fast as the receiver because obviously the receiver knows what the play is.
Trip receivers to the bottom of your screen here on third and 10. Iannotti has time, hangs in there, fires, and this one is knocked away. Pass a little bit behind Lamprakis, and C.J. Smith able to get in there and bat it away.
He's just trying to find a soft spot in the zone, waiting for the ball to beat the defender, because you know they're all going to converge to where that ball comes in, and Smith was the one who got there first. Pass was just a half a tick behind. Released it too late.
Third punt of the day coming up here for Mathewson. The Bison defense holds. Just a four-play drive that time for SIU.
Yeah, NDSU's defense has to be ecstatic so far to be able to close off three of the four possessions so far like this.
This one kind of a wobbler, bounces at the 35 and will roll down to about the 27-yard line. And that's where the Bison will have it with 2:17 to go here in the first quarter, leading 7-3. A smattering of Bison fans here today.
And we did see a North Dakota license plate when we were driving in today, too, didn't we?
Yeah, we certainly did. Take a look at our North Dakota Soybean Council trivia question. Today's question, what percentage of North Dakota soybeans are exported? We'll have the answer here coming up in just a little bit.
I suppose a lot is probably not a percentage.
I would think a large majority.
Another look in the offensive backfield from NDSU with the two backs to either side of Stick.
And Stick's going to keep it again, and Easton puts his shoulder down and picks up four up to the 31. The Bison have had some big chunks of yards on the ground, in particular in that last drive.
I honestly, Brian, thought that was going to be a bigger play because on the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, see number five, Allen. Allen goes with the running back, and so Stick sees that, keeps it himself. I thought that play was going to maybe pop a little bigger than it did.
The Southern Illinois defense does not play a ton of guys.
And they're not very big either, other than, you know, Golden goes 300, but other than that, not very big.
Darius Anderson gets the carry, his first of the game, and Anderson up to the 35 will bring up third and two.
Now, Coach Polasek says we got about 8 or 10 plays in the book for Darius Anderson, but will he get the opportunity to use many of those? He did right there.
Answer to your North Dakota Soybean Council trivia question, what percentage of North Dakota soybeans exported? 95%, so we were right again, LT.
See, I told you, it was a lot.
And coming off the field here is DJ Cameron, one of those safeties, a senior from Florissant, Missouri, making his 42nd straight start today.
Yeah, his third game of his freshman season is when he came in and got into the starting lineup, and he's been there ever since.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. He was the one that was in on that tackle of Darius Anderson. I think he was hit by his own guy, yep, who was also coming in.
Trying to see who that was
Leonard Gehring.
Gehring.
So big third down here for the Bison. Stick to throw to Darius Shepherd, and Shepherd gets a first down up to the 40-yard line.
Well, on third and short, the last a couple times ago, the Bison had it, not the possession where they scored. They went with the power play, the run. It didn't work. And now you're asking your wide receivers to get a block. Nice cut block out there by Erzendowski. Takes the legs out, the momentum away from the would-be tackler. Shepard's able to get squeezed just enough to get that first down.
Darius Shepherd again was battling an AC joint a couple of weeks ago. Still battled back to make a couple of huge catches against Northern Iowa. Now getting a little bit healthier every week. Back to the ground game. Frazier. Gains three up to the 43.
I mean, as much as you'll take a big, long run out of your quarterback, this is what NDSU wanted to do today. That's keep the ball out of the hands of the SIU offense. And you do that by controlling the game on the ground. It is what NDSU did so well last week down at Terre Haute. Especially on first down. I know that was a first down play there that only gained two, but boy, but last week that was the difference, the first down efficiency.
Well, the first quarter is over, and North Dakota State leads it 7-3. We'll be back with second quarter action from Carbondale coming up after this. Bison fans, as we take a look at the new seed fan cam, quite a few have made the trip down. Again, some of the guys, we certainly want to salute our veterans and servicemen as well, and women that are in attendance today. We did just see Garrett Clark get carted off, so it certainly appears that his day is over, which is certainly sad for the senior, who was playing well for SIU. Second and eight here coming up for North Dakota State at the 42. Pitch to the outside, that's Bruce Anderson, and King Frazier. And Frazier was taken out of bounds after a loss of one back to the 43.
Andrew McCree does an outstanding job, number 16. You see him on there. He takes up two of the blockers. And so Frazier just had to belly outside because he couldn't get it where the run point was. And the play was just stretched out right there by the junior. That's a fine job, taking on both those blockers and making that play go further outside than it's designed to.
So another third and seven here coming up for the Bison. Just one of two so far today. Stick to throw. Now he's going to take off with it. Easton Stick slips one tackle. Needs to get to the 50. He's going to be brought down a couple of yards short. So the Bison likely into a punting situation.
No lead blockers on this because Morlock flares out on an apparent trying to make a false read on a pass play, and the linebacker didn't bite when number 25 went to the flat, and so there was one extra guy in there, the guy who made the tackle on Stick and kept him away from getting that first down. So he did a good job of not getting fooled.
So we'll see what Ben LeCompte can do into the wind. This one goes through the end zone. So Ben, a 51-yard punt, but SIU will once again have pretty decent field position at their 20-yard line. Dale Lennon's crew hanging in. Down 7-3 on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Back with more from Saluki Stadium after this. North Dakota State leading 7-3 here in the second quarter. That is a look at Trey Dempsey, the Bison starting safety. And Beth Houle has a PetrolServe USA sideline report. Beth.
Hey, guys, another blow for this Bison defense. Trey Dempsey has a concussion. They've pulled his helmet. He's no longer in this football game, I'm told, from the sideline. It's a concussion. They will continue to observe him, but for now, we're looking at Bison defense needing to step up another man.
All right, thank you very much, Beth. And Mark Iannotti gaining 8 yards there on first down up to the 28-yard line.
And Dempsey coming off his best games was last week that he's played as for NDSU.
And Daquan Isom has a first down for the Salukis up to the 35-yard line.
First play was quarterback run, got you 8 yards. And in fact, the first two guys that hit the quarterback on that play were Grimsley and Winbush, your two safeties.
Iannotti out to Isom. And Isom's got room, and look out, he's a speedy freshman. Pushed out of bounds by Robbie Grimsley all the way inside Bison territory at the 41.
Well, Winbush just comes in to replace Dempsey, and on this play you're going to see him take the wrong route. Number 23 comes in, and then Isom is able to get upfield. And actually the Bison are probably lucky that thing only got to the other 40, to be honest with you. Winbush with the wrong attack angle really left that seam open.
Prakus, the man in motion. Iannotti calls his own number again. 5 yards inside the 40 down to the 36.
Boy, this is what he's done all year for Southern Illinois. I mean, second level guys are making first contact on the quarterback run they have so far during this drive.
Second and 5 coming up. Iannotti again will carry it. This time he is met at the line of scrimmage. Maybe got a yard up to the 34. A whole host of Bison on that play. Caleb Butler, Pierre G. Tucker, and Aaron Steidel.
Well, if you're a Bison fan, this is what you like to see. You see the white jerseys all sandwiched around Iannotti. Unlike the previous play where it's a corner who was the first one to hit him, that time there was a lineman on his legs and two backers on top of him, which is why it only gained 1 yard.
Third and 3 coming up. Iannotti will keep it. Iannotti has a first down inside the 30, down to the 29.
I mean, how many quarterbacks get this pad level? This is watch where he dips his shoulders, keeps his pads. He's running over his knees, pad level forward, running hard. Definite quarterback run. There's no option, nothing about that. Design call, let the quarterback, and you have that one extra blocker.
Iannotti to throw this time, and Iannotti, a whooping receiver, is Feeney. And Adam Feeney makes the catch inside the 5, down to the 4.
Well, Feeney's getting some looks from the NFL because of his size. He's 6'7", about 260 pounds, and he needed all 6'7", stretching out to get this one. Made the nice catch, the nice dive, and a late adjustment to the ball to get it to the 5.
Give this time outside. Jimmy Jones eludes two tacklers, and Jimmy Jones, 5 yards for an SIU touchdown.
Boy, at first, Brian, I thought the Bison bellied that play enough to keep it from getting into the end zone, but Jones was able to, on the wide side of the field, just able to make that one turn. G. Tucker with the one handle on him. Smith does not come up and make the tackle, so another safety getting an opportunity for NDSU. So already on this drive, I think we saw two big plays, including the touchdown, because Dempsey wasn't in there, that the Bison defense, just a hair out of position, made and SIU made them pay. You take advantage of, the guy's a starter and a guy's a backup for a reason.
80 yards in just over 2 minutes for SIU. And the home team, the Salukis, have taken the lead back. They lead it 10-7 here in the second quarter. Jimmy Jones coming up with the touchdown on the jet sweep there for Southern Illinois, and the Salukis have taken the lead back 10-7 here at Saluki Stadium in Carbondale.
He's really become a bigger part of the offense for the Salukis, especially the last three games. He's caught, I know that one was a run, but he's caught 20 passes and 4 of those for touchdowns in the last three games alone, so he's kind of emerged a little bit from that wide receiver group.
Another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. Perkins driven back inside his own end zone. He will take a knee, and the Bison will have it at their own 25. And North Dakota State at times has shown the explosive playability to LT, but they have not maintained too many drives so far. As we take a look at the Bobcat game recap, Southern Illinois' drive, boy, it didn't take very long. Just 8 plays, 80 yards in 2 minutes.
They've had a lot of drives like that this year. That's a lot of yards and not much time. And time, I think, is important now. Just see that 11:57 there on the bottom of your screen? This, I think, put that in the back of your mind and see how long the Bison control the ball on this drive. As fast as the Saluki scored right there to retake the lead, I think this could be, even though it's in the first half and early part of the second quarter, an important drive in terms of just keeping SIU's offense off the field.
Easton Stick will throw. RJ Urzendowski, working off a block from Zach Fry, will pick up 5 yards up to the 30.
in a perfect world, you can sneak another blocker out there, but it didn't happen in this particular play. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, slinging out to Urzendowski. You have Vrah taking care of one man, and then after a while, you see that pursuit coming at you. You don't really want to go back into it. You step around the outside, try to take as much advantage as you can of Vrah's block and get what you can.
That was actually a gain of three for Urzendowski, so second and seven coming up. Now three backs in the backfield here on second and seven.
I like this formation just because you can do so many things with it. And obviously Coach Lennon and the defensive staff did not like what they saw there. It's so balanced, you can do a number of things off of it. It's tough to try to make pre-snap reads for a defense with that backfield.
Coming into today's game, an interesting stat I found, Southern Illinois' defense has taken 139 more snaps than NDSU's defense has coming into this, and that is a product of the no-huddle offense they run. And talking to Dale about that is, you know, we are what we are, and we kind of have to live with that.
Which goes back to a little bit about, you know, when we were talking in the pregame show with Coach Lennon about, you know, this doesn't resemble the type of approach that you've coached before, and he's kind of, you know, turning play calling over to two different people on both offense and defense, and things are evolving. And Dale kind of indicated, hey, I've got to evolve too. You see Austin Kuhnert in there, the big brace on his left elbow. It was good to see Kuhnert back playing last week, played really, really well last week after injuring that elbow.
There's a look at Dale Lennon. Easton Stick is going to keep it, and Stick, again, taken down on the play by Kenny James. Also in there to make the stop is Jefferson Villa for a gain of one.
Boy, I thought the Bison kind of got what they wanted off the look. You'll see Morlock get a really good block right there, but then nobody can get into James. James was not fooled at all. He was not a half a step behind or ahead of the play. He was spot on, and that's why he's one of the co-leaders in tackles coming into this game. I know James is listed as a backup in the two deep, but there's no way that kid's a backup. SIU will play, they do right now. They have five defensive backs, they do that a lot. Six men up front.
Bringing pressure, Stick under pressure, is gonna flare it out. Had a receiver cutting at the last second was Urzendowski, but the pass is underthrown as Stick is hit. And a three and out for NDSU.
Yeah, Atkins was coming on a safety blitz, and because of that, there is no way that Stick could hold the ball much longer than he did. Both Shepard and Urzendowski were trying to make plays, adjustments to the ball in the air, but neither one of them could get there.
And Chase Allen came in and knocked Ben LeCompte. Now, if that's roughing or running into, we'll find out. I don't think a running into would be enough for a first down,
no,
but a roughing certainly would.
But don't be surprised at all that the Salukis are going for the block. They're, you know, they lead the country in blocked kicks, punts and kicks. They have seven blocks so far this year. Allen blocked a punt and a kick himself last week. Is he exposed? I would say yes. This, to me, looks like a first down. Does the leg is still up. Kicker still exposed.
Running into the kicker. Defense.
Oh, I'm
number
wrong.
Five. The penalty is declined. It'll be first down for Southern Illinois.
Okay.
So it was not enough for a first down, as it's called a running into, as SIU may have dodged a bullet there, and will take over at the 21.
What do you think? I thought he
when
was.
When the leg is
the
up
leg
and you're
still
hit,
there.
Usually that is called a rough.
I mean, well, Allen said, I almost got there.
Yeah, he and Brandon Williams each have three apiece.
Now, Allen's an interesting kid. He's about 90 minutes from here. He was just really rail thin when he got here. He was an outside linebacker. He matured kind of into his body, into one of the top defenders in the league, I think.
Look at Nick DeLuca and the Bison defense going to try to come up with a stop here as Iannotti will flare it out again to Reed, and Billy Reed trying to work off some blocks. Picks up 4 yards to the 24.
Fairly well defended by the Bison. Neither one of the defenders on those blocks, didn't give up either way. And then Wimbush was coming in to try to close it out. So a gain of about four.
Same play the other side to Isom. And this time Isom is stopped, still trying to wiggle out of a couple of tackles, but a whole host of Bison there to stop him. back at the 27.
Well, maybe that play will stop now, Brian, because I think the reason it was run on both sides were because of the angle that Winbush took on the one big long pay. Winbush was in position, number 23, the guy we're talking about who comes in and helps make this tackle. He played that very well to both sides of the field on those two respective plays. So I would be really surprised if Nick Hill goes back to that play anytime soon just because of the way that it appears that it was defended well by Winbush.
Third down coming up, 2 of 6. SIU on third down so far here today, 3rd and 7. Feeney the motion man. This dropped off in the flat to Aaron Stanton. That may have gotten 1 yard or two, but well short of a first down.
Yeah, C.J. Smith is in perfect position. He sees the catch made and then makes the stop. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
And another offensive lineman down for SIU. And again, they're already down Garrett Clark, who was carted off earlier today. And Jake Notario, another guy that's made 25 starts for SIU and really an anchor on the right side of that line, is down.
Podzielinski is his backup on the two deep chart.
This game brought to you in high definition by Speak Volumes. Reminding you that one drink isn't always one drink. Log on to speakvolumes.nd.gov for more information.
Well, just trying to read body language, and for his sake, I hope I'm right. It looks like this is not as bad as the injury was to Clark.
He is hobbling a little bit, but walking off under his own power.
And keep in mind, too, and you see a lot of quick little pass plays and stuff like that from Iannotti, but this Saluki offensive line has only allowed 4 sacks all year. They went a month without allowing a sack, 4 straight weeks.
That is 4th in the FCS and tops in the Missouri Valley. So Matthewson on to punt as the Bison defense gets a big stop to try to get the ball back to their offense here to get something going.
Really important stop after the Bison went 3 and out on that last play, or last drive, excuse me.
Matthewson. High, deep punt, driving Perkins back to his own 15. Perkins eludes a couple of tacklers, got another stop. Flag comes in for a black behind the back, so this is coming back as Perkins is taken down at the 40-yard line, and 2 flags came in.
Well, I don't think they actually called the first block in the back. This, I think, Brian, was the second block in the back that actually got called. But it's going to wipe out a really nice effort there from Perkins.
The Bison offense will be backed up now inside their own 10-yard line.
During the return, block in the back, receiving team number 18. Penalty tap distance from the spot. First down, timeout.
That's Kayvon Hawkins called for the block in the back. And the Bison backed up. 9 minutes to go exactly here in quarter number 2. Happy Halloween. 10-7, SIU leading here in Carbondale, Illinois, Saluki Stadium. The Bison have beaten the Salukis every year since 2009. So Southern Illinois trying to break that streak. And right now, so far so good, holding the Bison to just 7 points. Lance Dunn. And Dunn working off some blocks, and Lance Dunn has a first down, or close to it, up to the 18-yard line.
Well, a good lead block from Jedry Sear, and then watch the stiff arm here from Dunn. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. The perfect block, and then he gets away from Adkins and is able to pick up the first down because of that second effort after that contact with the good stiff arm.
Those runs to the outside, that was where Chris Kleiman said his hamstring may have affected him last week against Indiana State, and Tim Polisek said he's about 95% coming into today. Bison 170 rushing yards already today. Easton Stick will roll. Fire across the middle. Urzendowski was the intended target, and a flag comes in.
It was Kenny James on the coverage, and he comes up high and gets a hand in here. I don't know if it's going to be pass interference or maybe grabbing a helmet or face mask or a horse collar or whatever you want to call it, but he came in there hard and high.
Pass interference, defense, number 31, spot foul, automatic, first down.
And we'll give the Bison another first down now up to the 26. Brandon Williams putting the pressure on stick that time.
Boy, Easton doing a pretty good job knowing he's going to take a shot this time to get his shoulders squared up to get the ball downfield with some zip behind it.
Power play inside to Morlock, bouncing off a couple of tacklers, and then Chase Allen comes in to finish him off for no gain.
Well, you see the Bison do a lot of pre-snap movement, shift trade motion, just, you know, moving people around to try to affect the defensive scheme. And I thought that NDSU got what it wanted because SIU's defensive line all shifted to the defense's left, but that did not allow any hole to open up at all. Adam Brandt, you saw him, number 92, a senior. In on the tackle.
Second and 10 from the 26. Quick drop for stick. Fires on target a little bit low, but the pass caught by Erzendowski, good enough for 5 yards up to the 30.
I know Coach Kleiman talked about how stick is not uncomfortable in a drop back situation, but he's done more moving out and motioning and throwing on the move. The thing is too, and which Coach Hedberg said, is you got to remember that, you know, Carson Wentz is 6'6" and he can see much better in a straight drop back situation from the pocket, and it's a little bit more difficult for stick.
North Dakota State, 1 of 4 on third down. Coming into today, 51%. Three-man rush, stick is gonna take off with it, needs a 36, and Easton Stick dives ahead, using his legs up to the 38 to move the chains.
Well, certainly a pass play, no doubt about that, but one of the things they're doing with stick is making a half-field read, meaning you're not looking at the whole field and trying to find out where everybody is. So he's looking at your near side. There was multiple routes, didn't like any of them, covered fairly well, saw a little opening, and he took off. He did right there what he's been coached to do.
First and 10 from the 38. Stick, quarterback run, has blockers. Easton Stick now inside SIU territory, has another first down to the 49.
And this is a new play. This is a new play that NDSU has not run a lot, and the thing it's designed to do is get Morlock out there in a good position. And Chase is able to kick out, get the one guy on the outside out of there, and Stick is able to follow that block and beat the pursuit to the first down. A little bit of a different wrinkle that Southern has not seen a lot on tape.
Easton Stick now 7 carries for 89 yards here in the first half. Back to the ground game. King Frazier using a block from Jeremy Kelly, and Frazier picks up 6 yards up to the 43.
That's what the Bison want on first down, to stay what they say on schedule, get that, you know, first down efficiency. Last week, 62%, when the goal is to be in the upper 40s. This is exactly what you want on first down. That's first down efficiency, making it a 2nd and 4 situation, and now the playbook opens up a lot more for Coach Polisek.
Kenny James making another tackle. You can see why he is the leading tackler on this SIU team. Bruce Anderson's got room to the outside, and Bruce uses a stiff arm. James another tackle, but Bruce Anderson has a first down inside the 40, down to the 37.
Boy, control the edge, you get yards to the outside.
North Dakota certified seed producer stats report coming up at the half, so stay tuned for those.
Some running plays added to that stat report that you'll see, because Andrew Bonnet was one of the guys that really did a fine job. He had a little help, but you control the edge. If you can seal it off, obviously you see good things will happen, and the Bison are finding some success off the edge and to the outside. Same play again.
Easton Stick has more room to the outside, and Stick still in bounds, and now finally out of bounds at the 21. Enough for another Bison first down, gain of 16.
Well, you really put the defense in conflict on this play, because watch the motion of the offensive line and to where the fake goes. It's all going to the offense's right, and then Morlock and the quarterback are the only two guys going to the offense's left. And so your eyes and everything from the defensive perspective are saying to your left, to your left, to your left, and all of a sudden the ball pops off to your right. And another good run. That is a new wrinkle this week for NDSU.
And the Bison 105 rush yards for Easton Stick now. Lance Dunn. Nice job defensively that time by SAIU. Maybe got 2 yards. Another stop by Villa. Also in Marquise Jackson on the stop.
Well, I mean, you can easily tell where the success has and where, if you're a play caller, you keep going. You keep going, you know, to the outside. This play was, as you mentioned, Brian, covered up fairly well. But, you know, power on those short plays where you want to get a yard or two, it hasn't really been that good for NDSU. And so far, power hasn't worked up the middle as well as the Bison want it to.
Easton Stick will roll out. Has plenty of time, fires across the middle and caught by Luke Albers. And Albers down to about the 11-yard line, going to be very close to a first down. He might be about a half yard short.
Remember how I talked about you read half the field and you have multiple options in that half? This is Stick looking. He's looking long first. That's covered. Shepherd is the middle guy. He's covered. Your third option, the drag or the late guy into the pattern, and that's where you're tied in. And Albers was able to make that play.
So third and one coming up for the Bison at the 12. Jumbo personnel for the Bison on this third and short. Option, Stick will keep it. And he's got a first down to the 10-yard line.
Of course, if you can get to your goal of making the first down without jeopardizing the ball, meaning the pitch, you'll do it. So Stick will take the hit to get the first, because that's what the Bison wanted. And to be honest with you, he probably would have kicked it. I was thinking maybe two downs anyway, but if a kick ties it and Coach Kleiman's happy, he doesn't have to make that decision yet.
2.5 to go here in the first half.
The ball's right on the 10, so it is first and, you know, and goal.
An 83-yard drive so far for NDSU. Easton Stick will keep it again. Stick will fire, and it's almost caught and then dropped by Albers at the 3-yard line and incomplete.
Well, he really tried to jam that one in there, and if I saw it right when the play was happening, I think the pass is to his back left arm. It needs to be a little bit out in front of Albers. This was going to be a tough catch anyway for Luke, especially where the defender was. If that pass is out a half a body in front of him, I think it's made.
So second and goal coming up now from the 10.
But you can see, though, Stick is real comfortable rolling either way and passing either way. That's not really, you know, a big deal, and you have to roll to the right because he's more comfortable that way.
Chase Morlock gets the carry. Following blockers, Chase Morlock. Touchdown, North Dakota State.
Well, on second and goal, the Bison decided to be physical. Handed to Chase Morlock. Morlock is, he's one of those guys that's been banged up. His ankle's closer to being healthy. His AC joint and his shoulder's still not good, but he doesn't care. Morlock keeps those shoulders moving, keeps it churning, and gets into the end zone. Impressive drive from NDSU, and exactly what the Bison needed, because there was a good, 5 minutes or so off the clock.
Third touchdown rushing for Chase Morlock. And North Dakota State grabs the lead back with 2:15 to go. A 93-yard drive. Remember, this thing started all the way back at their own 7.
Well, do you have a word to describe it better than impressive? That was very impressive. Jedry Sear, the lead block. One of the lead guys. Real good pull there by Zach Johnson. Zach Johnson had a great game last week as well. Morlock's able to finish it off. In fact, Johnson, number 66, had 12 pancakes. That's not for breakfast. That's putting guys on their back, smacking them down at Indiana State. And so you get Johnson, a preseason All-American. He's getting more healthy. And, you know, Coach Kleiman talked about it. Coach Polasek talked about it. Hey, it's nice that we finally have our offensive line kind of intact again. It's been a while since the Bison have had that.
asking Coach Polasek about his performance with Easton Stick in his first career start. How did he handle it? And he said, you know, I talked to about a dozen guys on the offense, and they all said we're very excited about his future in this program. He really handles himself well.
And Tim said his teammates are the ones telling him that, so his teammates are excited for his success. That's a good sign, too.
Taking a look at our Bobcat game recap, North Dakota State, 13 plays, 93 yards, 6:45 as Chase Morlock darts in for the touchdown.
6:45, that's another minute longer than I was guessing at the time, so, boy, that was perfect.
Again, 2:15 is an eternity for Southern Illinois offensively.
It is, but remember another thing that Coach Polasek told us that I thought was kind of interesting. He said that a no-huddle offense, i.e., in this case, obviously the Salukis, when they're standing on the sideline and not playing, that offense can sometimes get frustrated when they're standing there and not being able to influence the game because the other offense is doing it.
Another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff by Ben LeCompte, taken at the 10-yard line. And the returner still on his feet. That's Jimmy Jones. And Jones takes it down to the 33-yard line. Jalen Winbush makes the tackle. And a flag comes in late, and I think that's going to be a late hit on SIU and will back up the Salukis.
It certainly is.
And Dale Lennon is furious.
He has every right to be extremely upset. It's either 40 or 46. The jersey's kind of folded up there. I couldn't see who it was. Take a really nice run on a critical part of the game with 2 minutes to go and a nice kickoff, and you move it 15 yards back. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Actually, I think LeCompte did what he was supposed to do, and that's kick it away from Isom number 5.
After the play, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, receiving team number 48, 15 yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
And that is the walk-on. Fullback Hans Carmian with the late hit, and that will back up the Salukis all the way inside their own 20 now.
Well, you see there, his jersey kind of tucked up. I thought it was a 0 or a 6. It ends up being number 48. There's a big difference between starting inside your own 20.
Mark Iannotti, 10 of 14 for 107 yards so far here in the first half. He fires this time and has a completion to Lamprakis. And Lamprakis gets out of bounds at the 26. Gain of 7.
That's one of the first plays that really just kind of hasn't been a 50-50 ball. That was more of a pattern and a timing route instead of just throwing it up downfield and waiting for your receiver to make a play on it. Nice little out.
Iannotti again will throw a little pass across the middle and caught by Isom. MJ Stump makes the big hit at the 31, but good enough for a first down.
Yeah, Isom couldn't get it. He had to number 41 pasted all over him before he was able to make an opportunity to get his feet and shoulders squared up to make a move on the defense. But when you only need a couple, you got the first.
Iannotti again, and this one is almost, or is it intercepted? He bobbled it, but he caught it. Jordan Champion has the interception. And now they're saying incomplete. Oh, boy.
Well, Champ thought he had it. The Bison off sideline certainly thought they had it.
Incomplete pass.
There is no replay available today, so this is not reviewable.
Oh, yep, incomplete.
It is incomplete.
Well, incomplete, not intercepted. You could see from where we were in our camera angle, we didn't see that ball pop down there at first, so obviously the Bison were hoping that ball would go their way. It did not.
Right in the hands of Champion as Iannotti back to the air. And this one is intercepted. C.J. Smith inside the 40. C.J. is a punt returner. And finally will be taken down at the 40-yard line. And the Bison in business with 1:29 to go.
Boy, you go from thinking you had the interception to the very next play knowing you have it. Iannotti tries to fire it off to his right.
Miscommunication. It looked like Lamprakis broke the route off LT.
Yeah, number one saw one thing, and your quarterback sees another. And I thought Winbush did a real nice job to not pace the guy behind, trying to make a block from behind, too.
Stump hit one from behind.
Stump got his shot in there. But right, you just saw it come and flash in front of your screen. Winbush was going to try to light a guy up, and then it would have been a block in the back and everything else. So he made a nice read to allow his guy to have, you know, his guy Smith in this case, make one more extra move instead of make it a penalty for sure. But now the Bison with a minute and a half to go.
And they do have all three timeouts. Second interception of the season for C.J. Smith, and now Chris Kleiman will call a timeout.
Timeout. North Dakota State, their first of the half, 30 seconds in length.
Coach Kleiman upset about something.
I don't know if it was not the right personnel group or there was a defense maybe. They were trying to see if the Salukis would be in and weren't, and you didn't have the right players for that.
It's interesting. Matt Entz was talking about that. He goes, we lead the country in pass breakups. We got to start catching more of these interceptions. We saw that with Jordan Champion, and finally CJ comes up with the interception for NDSU. And again, they haven't had many of them. Just six interceptions now this in the entire season.
But again, the big thing it does, the turnover, is it also keeps that explosive offense off the field.
Stay tuned for our hit of the game brought to you by American Family Insurance, DJ Coulter Agency. We'll have that for you coming up after today's matchup. And there has been some big hits already here in the first half.
A lot of room to the right side.
Stick will throw. Fires. Erzendowski makes the catch at the 31. Clock will continue to run. He's close to a first down.
He's short of it by a couple of yards because he had to come back for the ball. Stick was rolling to the near side. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. You see Shepard in the, he goes up. That's not to me. It's going to the man to the outside.
Now under a minute to go. Stick will run again. Easton Stick. Can see how quick he is with those feet. He's going to be about a yard short of a first down, and Chris Kleiman going to whistle for his second timeout with 43 seconds to go until halftime.
Yeah, if he gets the first down, then you don't need to use the timeout.
There's second of the half, 30 seconds in length.
But you saw James able to kind of slip around a potential block there. I think it was from Ilias, and he was the guy that prevented the first.
The Red Bears of Illinois State. 2 p.m. on November 14th.
And now you're starting to look at that one timeout used when the clock was not moving on play number one after the interception, and that could loom a little large here if the Bison don't get the first, they get the first and maybe need that timeout later.
Boy, the Bison running game, certainly Easton Stick a big part of that. He's got 110 rushing yards, but as a team so far here in the first half, 217 rushing yards. For NDSU.
Well, the fact that the Bison are running the ball, that's certainly no surprise. Anyone associated with the program told us that this week that was the most important thing for them to do. But the fact that you're getting explosive plays off of those runs to get as many yards as you just mentioned, Brian, that's the nice bonus. But right now the Bison need one more yard.
Well, the wind certainly in Peterson's face, so you wouldn't think a field goal attempt is in the cards from here. Third and one coming up. Bonnet is the motion man.
Double tight to the left.
Morlock. Plunges ahead inside the 30 down to the 29, and that will move the chains.
Interesting where you take your double tight end, put your most bodies off to the left, and then run it back to the right. So that Saluki's kind of adjusted off of that move, too.
Stick to throw. And now Easton is going to throw downfield. He had an open receiver in Vra, but it was well short. We'll bring up second and 10.
Yeah, Vra broke off his pattern, stopped at about the 10-yard line, was trying to work his way back to the quarterback, but Stick had to get rid of it too quickly because he's running out of room to get the pass play off. And Easton knows that as soon as he let that one go, that it did not have a chance, and he also knows that his receiver was open.
Now three receivers to the high side here.
This is where the Bison was. Had success in the past, especially when Brock Jensen was the quarterback, of using the tight end, but now Shepard comes to the near side. Movement. Head came up.
Looked like the initial movement was from the defensive end there. Kari Waith Alexander.
Oh, it's going to go against SIU.
Offside, defense number 41 was in the neutral zone and caused a reaction by the offense. It's a 5-yard penalty, second down.
Waith Alexander, but it was Leonard Guerin who was really the guy that moved. So now the ball inside the 25, down to the 24-yard line. And the clock will stop. Obviously, it was not running anyway. Shepard motioning to the high side of your screen. And another flag comes out. And this is going to be a false start, so now move it back to the 29.
False start, offense, number 70, 5-yard penalty, second down.
That's Jack Plankers. Looks like some time ran off the clock.
Shouldn't you keep the 29 seconds back?
The 29 seconds.
Please reset the game clock.
There they did.
The 29 seconds, 2-9. Thank you.
This is really a big drive for both teams, LT. If North Dakota State can extend this thing with a touchdown, they get the ball to start the second half as well.
Bison won the toss and deferred. Safety help over Erzendowski, man-to-man to the left.
Stick, hanging in there, going downfield, one-on-one, and flag. A flag comes in. The intended target was Zach Frah. In on the coverage was Torian Lewis, a true freshman from Lansing, Illinois, and he has been beat a few times in recent weeks and picks up a big flag there.
Flag into the end zone. You're giving your best receiver a chance to make the play. 50-50 ball, one-on-one.
Defense, number 14. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot, an automatic first down.
You can shake your head, young man, but there was no doubt about that. You did not even allow Vra's left arm to come up over his head to try to get both hands in a position to even make a play on the ball.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
Yeah, see the end of that? There's no doubt.
So now the ball
Morlock's
down to the 14.
Already like, give me those flags, boys, because that's pass interference.
And from here now, you're looking at a field goal attempt of about 32 yards.
One timeout, 22 seconds. We got a few plays to work with. But on the single receiver side, the Salukis have kept the safety over top, so you're not getting man coverage on Broad this time.
Stick to throw again. Inside screen to Morlock. Morlock inside the 10, down to the 8-yard line, and they're going to try to spike the football here and save the timeout. 10, 9, 8. Stick's got to get up to the center. Spikes it with 6 seconds left.
Well, the thing is, too, that Stick and Kunert have to make sure they don't snap it too early because everybody has to be in a set position. Your entire 11 men out there have to be in a position in the right spot on the field to make sure that there's no motion or anything that goes like that pre-snap.
So Cam Peterson on for a 26-yard field goal attempt into the wind.
Now Lennon will use the timeout.
Timeout, Southern Illinois.
Yeah, Dale was way down by the 10-yard line.
30 seconds in length.
In the ear of the head of the linesman.
And this is where you have to be aware too of LT, of both Brandon Williams and Chase Allen. Again, we talked about their special teams. They have a knack for blocking kicks.
Yeah, the two guys you just mentioned have three each, and the rest of the team has one. Tell you that SIU offense was not on the field much in that second quarter, though, were they?
No, they really weren't.
So that's goal accomplished for the Bison. And obviously Iannotti hurt himself and his offense by throwing that interception that allowed NDSU to get the ball with a couple minutes left and a chance now to add to the lead.
So we'll try it again. The true freshman Peterson has only missed once so far this season. Ben LeCompte to hold. And this one is up, and it is no good. Peterson just missed it, and NDSU unable to take advantage of the Southern Illinois turnover. Still lead at 14-10.
Well, you never want to leave points on the field against a team that scores more points than anyone else in the conference.
Take a look at the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. The hold and snap, everything looked good. He just pushed it little bit to the right. And Iannotti will take a knee, and Beth Hull will catch up with Chris Kleiman. As North Dakota State will take a 14-10 lead into the break.
End of the second quarter.
But I tell you, 10 points with a team that averages over 41 in the first half, not bad.
Certainly the turnover by Stick in the end zone hurt. Not getting the field goal there hurt, but the Bison, after everything, still lead it by 4. And Beth Hull now is standing by with Chris Kleiman for this PetroServe USA sideline report. Beth?
All right, Coach, finally able to get one of those turnovers you guys have been so hungry for. How important is that to keep that pressure from the defense?
Yeah, but we've got to turn it into points. We weren't able to do that, so it was all for naught.
You did get a long stretch of possession there, 7 minutes, nearly 93 yards with a score at the end. How important is it for the offense to continue that pressure?
Yeah, that was a great drive by our offense, defense. You can see how explosive they are, and they took it down and scored on us the one time. That's the kind of offense they can be, so we've got to do a great job possessing the football.
Thanks, Coach. Appreciate it, guys.
Thanks so much, Beth. Stay tuned. We'll have the Proceed halftime report coming up for you in just a couple of moments. North Dakota State on the road, leading 14-10 over Southern Illinois. Good football game here in Southern Illinois. North Dakota State and SIU. The Bison leading 14-10 on the road, looking for their second consecutive road win in as many weeks. Both teams making plays, LT, and what is going to be the difference here in the second half?
Well, maybe whoever stops quarterback run the best wins in the second half. You know that both Iannotti and Stick will continue to do that. And it would be important, too, I think, right off the bat here, Brian, if the Bison can go out and get a drive, just like that long drive that ended up, you know, with the touchdown, that 7 minute one. So maybe this time of possession thing, which was going to be a key stat anyway, becomes even bigger here in the second half.
Chris Adams, a deep boot through the end zone. And the Bison will start at their own 25-yard line here as they have the ball first here in the second half.
Well, 18:01 to just one tick under 12, so a six-minute advantage for NDSU in that first half.
Easton Stick, good first half running the football, 10 carries, 110 yards. And also throwing the football today, 8 of 12 for 40 yards, a touchdown and an interception. Everything's been pretty well short, LT. A lot of timing throws right off the chute.
Well, and the one that he really wants back is the interception in the end zone. That was a pass, as you mentioned, that was a little bit short. But it's always interesting to see as we come out to, if we can figure out or get a sense of what some of the halftime adjustments are going to be. I know for this SIU defense, halftime is always good for it because, again, they don't substitute much.
Power game, Jedry Sear, first through the hole, second through the hole. Is running back King Frazier, no gain to the 25.
Well, that's the biggest adjustment that I think the Salukis have to make is what are you going to do with that edge running game that NDSU was so good at in the first half. And a really nice play there by Cameron. You see him kind of duck under the pull block there. I think it was from Zach Johnson trying to get out in front of that. So he got a little bit lower than Johnson, got around his hip, and was able to make a play, no gain.
So 2nd and 10 coming up for the Bison. Stick to throw. Shepherd open in the flat. Dragging a tackler close to a first down. He's going to be about a yard short to the 34.
Fairly safe pattern. You have Vra on the outside running a fly, trying to get that corner upfield as much as possible. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, a little flip out to Shepherd. If he can break a tackle, fine. If not, he was so close to getting that extra yard he needed. But a nice little safe pitch and catch. Shepherd trying to make a move, gets 9 yards.
So Darius Shepherd making his second catch of the day. And another big third down here for the Bison. They were 4 of 7 in the first half. Power play to Morlock, and Chase going to need some help to get there. It's going to be close, and I think he's going to be about the length of the football short. We'll see will they mark him. They may have given him enough.
I think he's less than the length of, oh, geez, I'm wrong. The man in the white hat says first down. Morlock Boy just tries to muscle up, gets his back turned, keeps the legs going backwards as much as he can, and the nose of the football made it. I thought each one of the linesmen had him just a little bit short, but it's the guy in the white hat who determines whether it's a first down or not ultimately, and he said yes.
So the Bison moved the chains just barely on that opening series. Warlock now will split out to the high side of your screen.
Now you have a safety on Moody in the middle.
Stick fires downfield. Open receiver is Nate Moody. He has his first catch of the afternoon. Has enough for a first down up to the 46.
That's the reason that you send Warlock in motion. Chase goes way to the outside. Corner comes off of him, goes to the outside guy, Warlock. He's the decoy. Now you have the safety, number 31, James, one-on-one against Moody. Moody gets the 11 yards in this case needed for the first down. Well-designed play. You got the check you wanted and the read that you wanted, and it worked. That was also one of Stick's better passes, too. I thought he had pretty good velocity behind that, right on target.
Now back to the running game. Frazier ahead of steam. Got some good blocking up front. Kept the legs moving inside SIU territory to the 48-yard line. And then a flag comes in.
Well, the second effort made that a first. You know, we talked about that, how first down efficiency, getting that, you know, four or more yards on first down. And the Bison got six on that one just because of that second effort. I didn't see the flag. Did you see what it was?
Looks something extracurricular.
After the play, on sportsmanlike conduct, defense, number 2, 15-yard penalty from the end of the play, automatic first down.
So DJ Cameron.
First unsportsmanlike penalty on number 2.
There's been a couple of personal fouls that have really hurt Southern Illinois.
Just the extra shove, I guess, on the back. I think that was Bonnet trying to make a block, and we caught the very end of Cameron taking both of his hands and trying to shove the blocker down into the turf.
So that gives the Bison another first down all the way to the 35-yard line.
Yeah, there's another elbow, then another push, and now you're trying to walk over him and an extra knee. So perfect shot on the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay of where the penalty was and why it was called.
And this time the handoff will go to Bruce Anderson, who's been nursing some ribs. Injured last week against Indiana State, picks up 3 to the 30, will bring up 2nd and 7.
And through Wednesday, for sure, Anderson was not in any contact during practice, so I don't think it was going to be heavy contact on Thursday, and of course, travel day on Friday yesterday. So Anderson did not have any contact this week because of those ribs. And when he came out for warm-ups, we thought he's got like the double deep or the double thick flak jacket on. So they're really protecting those ribs on the freshman.
Stick is going to keep it this time, and he's got room inside the 20-yard line and enough for a first down all the way to the 19. And Easton Stick continues to run effectively. Now his 11th carry on the day for 121 yards.
Boy, he was just one half a step away. If he breaks that tackle there from Jackson, is able to step through that, he gets into the end zone. So Jackson prevented a touchdown on that particular play for SIU. But, boy, Stick is fun to watch run the ball.
The Bison inside the Superior Ink red zone. And when they get in there, they're pretty good at converting possessions to touchdowns. 78% of the time they score touchdowns in here. Inside screen, Lance Dunn. Nice play by Marquise Jackson. Working around to make the tackle for a gain of 2.
Now, once again, Jackson prevents a pretty big play. He's able to get down on the ankle, bring him down. At first, I thought Stick was going to try to hang in there. He couldn't. You saw the pressure, but Albers was trying to get open off to the left. Dumps it over the middle. Jackson closes out and gets the right ankle.
So NDSU trying to get more points here. They move down the field. Frazier works around one tackle, and how about King Frazier still on his feet? Inside the 10, down to the 5, and a flag comes in late.
Well, this is one of the better runs from Frazier in terms of finishing. He just jumping through and over and then blasting, and the pile keeps on moving, and then the flag at the end of the play.
Holding. Offense. number 46. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Repeat, second down.
So that will wipe out the first down run by King Frazier and bring the back ball back to about the original line of scrimmage at the 19.
Watch the left side of your screen, 46, that's Andrew Bonnet. He was the one who got called for the hold, and he does have Allen locked up. You saw Allen's right elbow was being held, the inside between his shoulder and elbow.
Frazier, not a lot of room that time. Good backside pursuit by Leonard Guerin, and Frazier lost a yard.
The run that Frazier had previous where the hold was, you saw where he did not have to juke or make a move or wait for a block, and this time he did. He had to step around. The real nice rush in there from Golden. Golden made the running back, forced him into an adjustment, and then Guerin, as you mentioned, Brian, was able to come in from behind or from the side and make that play.
Third and 12 coming up from the 20.
What a huge difference a penalty makes, though, huh?
Boy. SIU showing all sorts of pressure. Stick has some time. Now running out of time, and he goes down back at the 26-yard line. And I think Adam Brandt is the one that got in there for the sack.
Yeah, you're right. Number 92, Adam Brandt. The 2.5 sacks. Brandt's probably going to get credit for it. He was close to it. Alexander was also close to it.
This will be a lengthy field goal now as Cam Peterson is driven back.
But the wind is down, though, Brian. It's down.
42-yard attempt. Snap, good. Hold down. It is up, and it is no good. Again, it's wide to the right. And North Dakota State unable to take advantage of another scoring opportunity, and their lead remains 4.
Boy, it sure looks like you're powering your way into the end zone. The holding penalty disrupts the entire drive. And this again will hang out to the kicker's right, to your left, hoping you can get it to hook, and it's not coming close. Well, you never know what's going to happen on the interception into the end zone, but if you're going to assume that if nothing else you get a field goal attempt out of that, that's at least 9 points now. You have to figure that NDSU is left on the field and the Bison still have the lead.
It's a run around the end there for Jimmy Jones, who gets 3 yards to the 29.
Boy, he tried to sneak around DeLuca, and DeLuca almost took him hard up high.
Second and 6 here for SIU.
Boy, and you know again that this Saluki offense has just been waiting and chomping.
Across the middle to Lamprakis, and Iannotti stood in there and took a hit from G. Tucker. Incomplete. Third down coming up.
Boy, these are the types of catches you have to make. Your quarterback is taking a big-time pop in order to get this ball downfield and on target. Yeah, that's a little higher than I thought. I thought he had both hands on that to begin with, but Lamprakis is not real tall. He's only 5'11". But look at all the turf still on Iannotti. He was hit pretty hard.
SIU 2 of 7 on third down in the first half. Bison bringing pressure. Iannotti rolls, fires, and this one is incomplete. Brad Ambrosius was actually back in coverage with a couple of other defensive linemen.
Because Grimsley and somebody else came. Watch number 35. Grimsley's the guy putting most of the pressure on. So to accommodate that, you drop, in this case, Ambrosius. The Bison do that a lot with their defensive ends. They're athletic. Stanley Jones has done it a few times as well. So it's not like the first time they've ever done that. But it gives Grimsley has to run a little bit further, but more of a freer chance to get to the quarterback.
So North Dakota State had the ball over 6 minutes. SIU had it for about 50 seconds. Perkins will take it at the 20. And good special teams pursuit. Yeah, Allen. That's the guy we talk about all the time, Chase Allen. 14-10, your score on the Ag Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. The Bison have the football back when we come back. North Dakota State controlling things when you look certainly at the statistics. As we take a look at the Bobcat game recap, total yardage, NDSU 304 to just 179. And of those 304 yards, 243 of them have come on the ground for the Bison. Drive starting first and 10 from the 21. Dunn has room. Lance Dunn lost the football, and I think SIU's got it. Another turnover as Lance Dunn coughed it up.
Check out number five. I think it's Allen that comes. Nope, he was blocked on the play, but he'll follow the play and make the recovery.
And just like that, SIU is ready to roll.
They're going to roll the offense out here and try to get going with it, but yep. Well, when your offense can't get you first downs, your defense is helping out the offense, and they came up big that time, creating the turnover.
Second turnover of the afternoon for the Bison, and SIU on a short field. Iannotti to throw. Fires. Jimmy Jones makes the catch inside the 15, right at the 15-yard line. Good enough for a first down.
Jones started all the way to the left side and ran a long drag route. And the further that his quarterback moved to his right, Jones just kept going as well to that side. He ran across the face of Winbush. Winbush was in decent position, but still the pass put right on the money.
Iannotti will run it. Iannotti puts his shoulder down, lost his helmet, and taken down after a gain of one.
So he'll have to come off for one play. Here comes McIntosh.
Ambrosius making the tackle for NDSU as we take a look at the note at Mutual Insurance replay.
Ambrosius was in there. He had some help. G. Tucker also in. Also in on the play.
Gain of a yard, second and nine from the 14.
You'd have to guess it would be run. McIntosh has not thrown many passes this year.
Hands it off that time to Stanton. He is swallowed up from behind by Brian Schatz. Back at the 21.
Schatz on a little bit of a slant. He blew through the gap, and the play was called right into where Brian was. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. No chance on that play. He just blew right past the offensive lineman, Austin Olson, and got in there.
Third and 11 coming up for SIU.
Olson was trying to stretch it to his left and get in front and couldn't do it.
Iannotti back in the game. Iannotti to throw, has time, fires, tipped, and incomplete. Dangerous throw across the middle, looking for Jimmy Jones, and that will likely bring in Austin Johnson for a field goal attempt.
Yeah, DeLuca, 49, dropping back in pass coverage, and the thing you're trying to do as a quarterback is get it over the linebacker and in front of your defensive back, and it did not get over the linebacker. Here's a really nice play. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay again as DeLuca making a play on the ball and another pass breakup.
So Johnson hit a field goal earlier from about this distance. This one, like one earlier, 31. This one about 33. It's down. It is up. And it is good. So Southern Illinois able to cash in and get 3 points off the turnover. And Dale Lennon's bunch pulls within one. It's 14-13 on the Ag Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Taking a look at your Bobcats game recap. Five plays, just 10 yards, and 119. The Johnson field goal gets SIU even closer. Of course, the Lance Dunn fumble setting it up.
But you know what, Brian? I still think that's a win for NDSU. You get a quick change against an offense that's just chomping to try to do something. You hold them to a field goal, and you still have the lead. Not the worst thing in the world that could have happened in that situation following the fumble.
Another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Stop your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. Kickoff comes to Perkins at the goal line, and he will bring it out. Has some blocks in front of him, and Perkins taken down at the 22-yard line, and that's where the Bison will have it.
Well, if nothing else, you can tell how the wind has gone down a little bit, because that's the first kick going that direction that's been returned all day. From the goal line, Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Perkins trying to survey and adjust as much as he can on the way up. That was Carmine, fullback, with the tackle on the special teams play.
Easton Stick 11 of 15 today for 61 yards.
Yeah, his percentage is good. It's not a lot of yards.
Stick to throw. comes back across the middle. Ooh, dangerous pass. His number 31 lucky. Came in there for SIU, Kenny James.
Big time lucky. Stick didn't see what he saw of what he wanted on this first half of the field, made a quick adjustment off to the back half, which he has not been asked to do a lot of this year. Well, he got lucky. That could have been six the other way if the pass is up a little higher.
You see in the game number 88, Shaq Findletter. This is only his second game as defensive end. He's been a tight end the last couple of years in this program.
He was a tight end last week.
Yeah, he actually caught a two-point conversion against Youngstown State. There's a run for Chase Morlock. Not much room this time. Stacked up, coming in to make the tackle. He is number 99 there, one of the defensive linemen, Dakota Upchurch for SIU.
Really good flow, I think, on the defense. You saw no lanes open at all for the Bison to try to pick away. Real good flow, real good steady pressure right at the line of scrimmage. Nice job for the Salukis.
Third and eight coming up.
Boy, the last thing the Bison want, obviously, is to go three and out here.
Stick has protection across the middle. Open receiver, he's got Erzendowski inside SIU territory. Down to the 20. Erzendowski's going to go. Touchdown, Bison. 78 yards for RJ Erzendowski.
Well, the last thing you wanted was three and out. The biggest thing you wanted was the touchdown. Erzendowski will come into the screen from your left. Zips the pass to him. Great throw. And then Erzendowski just beats the defensive player, makes the lunge, and big plays again, the thing that has haunted SIU, and the Bison just put one on them. That's what NDSU needed.
Boy, huge play on third and eight. Peterson on for the extra point. Boy, penetration there by Chase Allen, but it is through, and North Dakota State has gotten some momentum back. Easton Stick to RJ Erzendowski, 78 yards, and the Bison lead at 21-13 on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services School Board.
Time out on the field. Ooh.
Easton Stick, a big play to his former high school teammate, RJ Erzendowski. And yeah, it's that Creighton Prep connection out of Omaha once again. And North Dakota State gets a big, well-needed pass play.
It's the SIU offense coming in, noted for its explosive plays, but there the Bison just turned the table on them. And on that replay, you saw that. We were wondering where the safety help was. Well, it was the safety that he burned. So nice job by Erzendowski and a beautiful pass.
Isom from his own goal line. Isom dangerous. Taken down from behind. It looked like Dan Marlette came in to make the tackle, the redshirt freshman from Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Take a look at the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Number 48 coming into your screen here.
And he spins and stays on his feet and then gets down to the feet of Isom. Again, he's the dangerous guy. He popped a 75-yard screen pass against Youngstown, and he's had a couple of big ones. And dangerous whenever he has the ball because he has a lot of speed.
DeSomer out in motion. Back screen to Jimmy Jones. Bison, not fooled, as C.J. Smith right there to push him out of bounds for a minimal gain, maybe even lost a yard.
Well, you've got an experienced corner who you're trying to fool, and Smith is not fooled on this play. He was 3 yards behind any potential blocker, so I tell you, Smith right there, C.J. read that as well as you possibly could. He was in there, made the play, and lost, what, about 3 yards on it.
Ended up losing three. And Adi across the middle. Feeney juggled it and dropped it at the 28. So that will bring up third and long. This game being brought to you in high definition by Parents Lead. Have conversations with your children that matter. Log on to parentslead.org for more information.
SIU needs to get across the 35 for the first down.
And flags, and I think we have a false start, and that's going to make it even tougher.
False start, offense, number one. 5-yard penalty. third down.
But you saw Coach Entz dial up what was effective earlier. That's bringing Grimsley from his safety position and dropping Ambrosius into the pass coverage. Now it's going to be a little bit of a different situation because Jordheim comes in for Tangway, so the Bison are going to go with max coverage, it looks like, here.
And just three defensive linemen.
5-9 warning. North Dakota State, the one warning of the game. No yardage.
So sideline warning on the Bison as they were getting a little too jumpy getting on the field. See Caleb Butler in on the game here on third down, and Jordheim kind of one of those guys that can blitz or play coverage. They'll show a lot of different looks out of this for North Dakota State.
Rush three.
Iannotti has time, now flushed, fires, and this one is out of bounds, too high.
Oh, Jordheim's going to get a late hit on the quarterback.
And a flag comes in late, and oh boy, that would keep.
Keep the drive going.
The drive going on a personal foul. Wow.
Personal foul. Run from the passer. Defense, number 45. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot and an automatic first down.
So an automatic first down. Instead of SIU punting from their own 15, they'll have a first down up to the 32.
Up two steps, and then he hit him after the pass was thrown. I mean, it was defended well. Everything except the hit, the late hit. And it's not the yards that were the big thing on that penalty call. It was the automatic first down.
Jordheim, the redshirt freshman from Dickinson, a walk-on. Iannotti's going to run with it. Boy, the Bison have just had him covered up all game long. He has not squeaked through as Ambrosius makes another tackle.
Well, it's been no secret that quarterback run on the run option has been an issue. And the Bison have kind of changed the way that they're defending it. Instead of spilling it, which they've done for five, six games, they're trying to box a little bit more. And that time, Ambrosius stayed in the box, and Iannotti ran right into it. Stump was also right there as well.
10 carries, 32 yards for Iannotti, and this is a little running pass. Reed makes the reception. Wimbush comes up to make the tackle, and right at the first down marker, I think he's going to have enough up to the 43.
Well, a lot of read option is read on the run. This is a read option to the pass. Iannotti fakes it, sees the single coverage on the outside with one extra blocker help, zips it to the sideline and stretches it to the first.
Iannotti's going to keep it again, puts the shoulder down, and once again taken down after the minimal gain of one by Nick DeLuca, who's seemed to make a lot of tackles so far today.
But remember when Coach Entz said that SIU does not care how many hits he takes, meaning the quarterback Iannotti? There's an example there. He's just plowing in there, kind of like a fullback almost would. You know he's going to get a big hit, and DeLuca was the guy that smacked him down pretty hard.
Second and nine from the 44. Jones again in motion. Inside handoff. And room to run this time. And that's the first carry of the day for number 39, Jonathan Mixon. Another one of those freshman running backs from Galesburg, Illinois. And enough for a first down as SIU trying to take advantage of the personal foul on NDSU.
Pretty good gap to run through. Well blocked.
Iannotti looking to run again. Tangway, among others, there to swallow him up for no gain, maybe a yard up to the 44.
Well, he's 46. Not going to get the tackle, but Menard, 96, is the one who makes the play. He was able to get off his block and then and force the quarterback down in as a Bison player is slow to get up. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Brian Schatz, I think, is the guy who is down, if I read the number right, but... Yeah, Tangway makes the tackle, but Menard played it very, very well.
Schatz, the senior, former walk-on from Denmark, Wisconsin. Have a few minutes. Let's take a look at our North Dakota Soybean Council trivia question. Today's question here in the second half is, American consumers spend what percentage of their income on food? The answer for you coming up. LT, guesses.
Depends. Are we on an expense account or not? Okay, we're trying to pick up
number 61, Brian Schatz.
Number 61. He's just off onto the left of your screen, tangled in. I don't know. It looks like he kind of stepped on almost.
His hand.
Yeah. So Morgan is in now at that defensive tackle.
NDSU. Again, reading. And it's the quarterback keeping again. And Matt DeSomer came in that play and picked up a couple of yards up to the 44. So third and seven coming up. Again, DeSomer has a rush, a catch, a punt return, and has completed a pass this season.
But he
so far
was the scout team quarterback last year, so he's not unfamiliar with the position. He's just been moved to wide receiver.
A little big third down for SIU.
Remember, the Bison had him stopped earlier and then the penalty.
2 of 9 on third down today for Southern Illinois.
Third and about seven.
Arenati will throw. Across the middle, it's complete to Lamprakis. And Lamprakis makes a big catch. Up to the 30-yard line, he's got a first down. Jalen Allison on the coverage.
Well, I thought Iannotti stayed in the pocket pretty well and delivered a nice ball. And Bison had two players in the area, but he fit that thing in there well.
Iannotti is going to take off with it this time. More room up to the 25-yard line. And they'll continue to go quick.
Yeah, Stumpf gets cut a little bit. Yeah, he had a really nice block on MJ Stumpf, and number 41 couldn't get in there to close the gap, which is why he gained about five.
Iannotti again will swing it out to Jimmy Jones. And Jones down the sidelines. Jimmy Jones, his second touchdown.
This drive you thought was halted almost a couple of times. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. You're going to see Wimbush come up here. Number 23, he's the kid that needs to make the tackle. He whiffs on it. And then it's smooth sailing down the sideline. Coach Lennon is going to go for the tie right here, too.
I want to go for the two-point conversion to try to even it up at 21 apiece. Look at Bill O'Boyle, the offensive line coach there for Southern Illinois. We'll see what the Salukis dial up here in the two-point conversion. Iannotti will throw across the middle. Incomplete.
Bison still lead.
So North Dakota State maintains a two-point lead after Jordan Champion was in on the coverage.
Not much zip behind this pass. You see G. Tucker come in, and then Iannotti had his momentum going backwards and tried to flip it right into Lamprakis, and it just the connection wasn't there. They've tried to hit him a couple of times over the middle. Again, he's a smaller type of a receiver. Incomplete. Bison still lead.
Answer to our North Dakota Soybean Council trivia question. Again, we asked American consumers spend what percentage of their income on food? 10%. Look at Thundar, who has made the trip south here to Southern Illinois. And now let's take a look at our Bobcats game recap. Southern Illinois, again, as you mentioned, LT, really taking advantage of the extra down off the...
Yeah, the first down off the penalty.
First down off the penalty. 11 plays, 75 yards in 4 minutes as Jones scores his second touchdown. And the Bison lead is trimmed back to two.
Well, the offense's job for the Bison right now is to give that defense a break, because it was the defense's, you know, own fault due to the penalty that they were out there for that entire 11-play drive, the drive that almost tied the game up. The two-point didn't happen. So right now, I think it's real important for the offense to kind of, you know, control things here for a little while and give your defense a chance to catch back up with itself.
Time for another Peterson Farm Seat kickoff. Peterson Farm Seat probably brings you a Bison kickoff as well as a product lineup that will give you every reason to stand tall.
So he'll have a chance if he wants it. Nope.
He's going to wisely, I think, taking the in. The Bison will start at their own 25.
First thought he was going to get it about the goal line, but it ended up being about 2 or 3 yards deeper than that.
Easton Stick, a big connection to R.J. Urzendowski on the Bison's last drive, and we'll see what the Bison can dial up here.
Well, I know they're a part of every football game, obviously. They meaning penalties is what I'm talking about here, but you go back to the hold on King Frazier's run inside the five, And you go back to the, you know, the personal foul on the late hit on the quarterback, and those are two massive plays that have influenced this third quarter. Now that 78-yard touchdown pass really looms large for NDSU, still holding the lead. They got the big explosive play.
Frazier following blocks. Pretty good blocking up front that time as he picks up 6 yards to the 31.
That was great movement by the offensive line right off the bat. That is the NDSU would like about 10 more plays just like that one. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay will get a good look. Kuhnert moves his man at the nose, so he clears it out and allows Johnson to get a good lead up through there. Yeah, when you can clear the nose that well, which Kuhnert did on that play, it's an easy 6 yards.
Shepard's gonna get the carry, and Darius Shepard has room to the outside, all the way up to the 48-yard line, and enough for a Bison first down.
Yeah, DJ Cameron's the guy who thinks he has a shot at him. Shepard on a jet sweep across, he gets the handoff. You'll see number two come in there, tries to spin away, but he can't spin off his block. Chase Morlock again down the field. He's had a good day in terms of blocking people. The Bison get the coveted first down.
Now under a minute to go here in the third quarter. EC Stick is going to take off with it. Gets to midfield. Gain of three will bring up second and seven. And that may be the final play of the third quarter.
Just because Morlock was in the backfield, but he wasn't in a position where NDSU normally would hand off to him. You get the jet motion there from Williams. And so that play, before it started, certainly looked like Stick was going to keep it. And the Bison will take care of the third quarter here.
Won't have to move the ball much. Maybe about a half yard to the other side of the 50. And yes, it's the fourth quarter.
The end of the third quarter.
So raise up your four, because it's time for the 4 for 4 from PetroServe USA, where you can get the $4 pizza special, which includes pizza, two cookies, and a drink at all 24 PetroServe USA locations. We'll be back with the fourth quarter after this. You're watching NBC North Dakota Sports. Let's take a look now at our New Seed fan cam, and we got all sorts of kids and adults, for that matter, dressed up today as we celebrate Halloween. As the Bison fans holding up that four for the fourth quarter, hoping their team can finish strong here on the road.
Boy, the Bison would love to finish this drive right at midfield into the end zone to get some points here. Still leading by two, but NDSU with over now 413 total yards so far.
Back to the power game. King Frazier is loose inside the 30, the 20. King Frazier, touchdown, Bison.
Another explosive play on the ground for NDSU. And when you check the replay out in this one, you'll see why it went for a touchdown. The inside, this is the best that NDSU has blocked the power today. They haven't run it a lot, but they've moved people. There were about at least five maroon jerseys going backwards. That was outstanding work on the offensive line, and Frazier did what he's supposed to do, and that's get as much as you can, and he got 50 on it, or 49.
North Dakota State up to 325 rushing yards on the day, and they have taken the lead and extended it once again and lead it by 9. It is 28-19, North Dakota State. King Frazier from 50 yards, and the Bison on track for a big lane as the seas part from the 50. We'll be back in a minute.
Timeout on the field.
North Dakota State extending the lead to 28-19. Four plays, 75 yards, capped off by King Frazier, 50-yard touchdown run.
I thought the Bison were going to have to grind a little bit more to get those 7 points. But no, they they, meaning the offensive line for NDSU, just pulverized the interior of the Saluki defense on that 50-yarder. That was gorgeous blocking.
Comp does have the win now, a little bit that's remaining, and kicks it out of the back of the end zone. So SIU will take over, down 9 at their own 25. Again, NDSU playing without Trey Dempsey since early in the game after a concussion that he likely sustained on that big hit on Matt DeSilver. Concern about the defensive line, how their health would stand up. And, you know, we've seen quite a few reps out of Greg Menard and Brad Ambrosius today.
Yeah, they've played more than we're led to believe. But, of course, you have that adrenaline of a game day that certainly helps. Safeties right now are Grimsley and Winbush.
Jones motions in the backfield. And dropped the football. That thing is loose. And I think that's North Dakota State.
Called it incomplete.
Oh, boy, I thought that was behind.
The headlinesman on the far side called it incomplete right away, but that was dangerously close.
Second down.
No guy mutual insurance replay.
That's a lateral. But again,
no replay.
There is no replay today because SIU elected not to have it. Is that correct?
That, from what I understand, it was the home team's call on what they wish to do.
They can break for the Salukis right there.
Iannotti will run, and he's got room. Iannotti has a first down up to the 36.
Spread him out to run the quarterback. Salukis do it well right there, and this one was dangerously close to going big. Grimsley had to sneak around where the umpire was and kind of got his angle off a little bit. I tell you, that looked bigger than it ended up being.
Iannotti to Lamprakis. Boy, big hit. How about MJ Stump coming up to stop Lamprakis in its tracks for a loss of one?
Well, we have a candidate for hit of the game.
Ooh, that's definitely up there.
Lamprakis has been targeted quite a few times here. Just a little slant trying to get inside and get what he can. And what he got was a hello from MJ Stump.
Iannotti will run again. And Iannotti, good yardage up to the 44, will bring up third and two.
But really, C.J. Smith does a good job on this play, and it could have ended up maybe being a little bit bigger because he jumps to the outside. Smith knows that he has to be the furthest guy on the outside of that play. Yes, they gave up some yards in the middle, but that's where the tacklers are going to come from. If Smith stays inside and gets pinned or hooked and allows Iannotti to come outside, that could be much bigger than it was.
And a flag comes out.
Sideline interference. Bison sideline.
Delay a game.
Yep.
Sideline interference on the defense. This is their second infraction. That'll be a 5-yard penalty, which results in a first down.
Bison just warned about that a few minutes ago, and now it results in a first down for SIU.
It's one of those deals where we can't say we didn't warn you. Officials certainly did. That's why that big white stripe on the out of bounds, there's no one supposed to be in that. I mean, the coaches can be in there.
Iannotti will run. Boy, again, it's Nick DeLuca right there at the line of scrimmage to make the tackle for no gain.
Well, in the quarterback run, as much as he does from the interior, you have to try to do something against the middle linebacker. And he was untouched. And DeLuca untouched is a good thing for NDSU because he does not miss very often.
Second and 10 coming up.
Not only does he not miss, but he usually hits you pretty darn hard.
Now under 13 minutes to go here in the football game. Jones the motion man. Iannotti will keep and is under pressure. And down he goes back at the 43.
Corner blitz.
C.J. Smith coming up with the sack.
Iannotti was not ready for that one. He was looking off to his right. Smith has a smile on his face because he knows he got there. And all of a sudden, Iannotti tries to step up in front of where Smith comes. He can't get there. Iannotti can't get there. Smith was on the blitz. Matt Entz dialed up a gamble call, and it worked. Third and long.
Third and 15. Iannotti stepping up across the middle and caught by Jones, and he has enough for a first down at the 41.
Well, not only caught by Jones, but that was a real nice catch. The ball was a little bit behind him to pick up. Well, you needed 16 for a first down. That one got 17. That's a nice job on the ball, running a deep slant, trying to split the zone, waiting for his quarterback to hit one of those zones, and he did.
Jones getting the carry, and that thing was bellied out. Nice job defensively again by C.J. Smith for a loss of five.
That was Champion. That was number five, Jordan Champion, that made the play. He played off his block. The whole key to making that work, and as it worked for the touchdown, is to take care of the corner. Champion is a very good run stopper from that corner position. He busted through the block and threw it for a big loss.
So second and 15 from the 45. Iannotti fade pattern on Champion.
Can't play it better than that.
Nice job defensively by Jordan Champion. Intended target for SIU was Kyle Newquist, a seldom used wide receiver.
Perfect position, hip on hip, inside. When the receiver turns and looks, you turn and look. Two real nice plays, one in the run game, one in the pass game by Jordan Champion.
And a third and long now again for SIU. They just converted one a moment ago.
About a yard shorter, maybe. Yeah, third and 15.
Let's see if the Bison bring any pressure. And now I think Dale Lennon saying we're going to call a timeout and try to get this thing right. A huge play in the game.
Timeout. Southern Illinois, their first of the half. 30 seconds in length.
There's a look at Dale Lennon.
I mean, Dale's in that situation. Lennon's not the one running out there to call timeout. He's on the headset and talking to Nick Hill, the offensive coordinator at this point, and Nick Hill's the one saying, don't like it, give me a timeout. And so Coach Lennon obliges, obviously, because the guy who's calling the plays doesn't like either the look, the set, or the personnel.
And Dale Lennon replacing Jerry Kill, who had great years here at Southern Illinois. A lot of people think is maybe the one person that not only got this stadium, but even kept football around. It was insignificant for several years. He came in and won. Beautiful brand new stadium here, and we certainly want to send our thoughts out to Coach Kill, who was forced into retirement due to some health concerns earlier this week at the University of Minnesota.
Yeah, we talked a little bit about it on the pregame show, but if you weren't with us, yeah, a lot of people, because of which Coach Kill was able to accomplish here, give him credit for starting the fund drive that created $30 million to build this place.
And Jerry Kill was one of those people who did not want NDSU in the Missouri Valley. He was pretty adamant about that. SIU did vote for them, but it was not because of Coach Kill. Iannotti under pressure, stayed on his feet, and now he's just going to throw it up to Lamprakis, and he made the catch inside the 20, down to the 15. Wow!
Oh, my goodness. How did the quarterback keep this play alive? Talk about a 50-50 ball, throwing it up and hoping your receiver can make a play. It's exactly what happened. And now all of a sudden, the Salukis are knocking on the door again.
On third and 15, Iannotti will run again inside the 15, down to the 11, gain of four.
And there was a third and 16 on this drive that was picked up earlier. Well, there's a reason that he has the numbers he has, and he's doing the things he is doing this year, because somehow he finds a way to make it happen, and Iannotti's done it on this drive.
Fade pattern to Reed, knocked away. C.J. Smith again on the coverage. Will bring up another third down.
Actually, I thought that was Allison.
Oh, was it Jalen Allison in on number 21 that was in on the coverage? Excuse me.
Yep, that was Allison that knocked it away.
The redshirt freshman from Papillion, Nebraska.
Third down's been the money down for the Salukis on this drive.
SIU has found a way in these situations. Play clock down to six. Iannotti under pressure again, steps out of it, and then just throws it out of bounds. And he was planted on the play by Greg Menard as he threw it. So field goal situation for Austin Johnson to try to pull the Salukis within six.
Yes, Smith gave a little false read right off the tap, like he was going to come again from the corner. And then there you see the big hit by Menard. Nainati knew he didn't have a chance to complete it, but he wants to give his kicker the best opportunity, and that's not to take a loss on the play.
28-yard attempt. Johnson is 2 of 2 today.
Took a while, but the Bison got a third down stop.
Johnson boots it up, and it's good. Austin Johnson has had his problems, but not today. 3 of 3 now from field goal range of 31, 33, and 28. And SIU within 6. It's 28-22 with 10:26 to go from Carbondale.
Timeout on the field.
North Dakota State leading 28-22 as we take a look at the Bobcat game recap. 14 plays in that drive for 64 yards, and of course, two huge third down and long conversions for the Saluki offense.
Well, I know it's Halloween, but I think Iannotti is going as a magician. Because he pulled off some magic on a couple of those third and longs.
Iannotti, 20 of 34 for 223 yards and a touchdown and an interception. So Adams on to boot this one away. It's another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff.
Bison will have a chance for the return here. That's been the way it's gone in this end of the field.
Perkins at his own 9. Perkins through a crease. Eric Perkins bounces outside. And a big return for Eric Perkins all the way to the 44-yard line.
Boy, they gave him a nice seam. Perkins was able to find this one easy. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. You'll see him come upfield, and then it just parts. Couple of really key blocks. Sidesteps one tackler and gets about another 10 yards after that. And you're up to midfield already, near it. Bison cannot be done scoring, I don't think, in this game.
After a 35-yard return, the ball is placed at the Bison 43. First and 10 for North Dakota State.
It's also a drive, I think, that NDSU's offensive line would love to dominate right here.
Frazier has room to the outside, and King Frazier's broken up another big run. Inside Saluki territory, down to the 10, and King Frazier still going as a flag comes in.
There's a face mask in here too, I think, trying to bring Frazier down because there was no NDSU player anywhere in there. But Andrew Bonnet threw a beauty. He blasted two Salukis by himself to the turf, which helped open up the outside.
Man, was there room on the outside.
Personal foul, face mask, defense, number 24. Penalty is half the distance from the end of the run. First down.
See if we can see Bonnet somewhere. Well, actually, he took out three different guys. Two of them fell down, and one stayed on his feet but was out of the play.
And Ryan Neal finally made the tackle after making contact at about the 25-yard line. Ryan Neal, of course, the brother of Mike Neal, who plays for the Green Bay Packers.
That didn't take long to get down to the 3.
Boy, oh boy, was that a big play from King Frazier, who's now over 100 yards. 174 yards for King Frazier today on 14 carries.
Just when I think the Bison offensive line needs to grind it, bang, there goes a big offensive run.
Morlock following blocks. Chase Morlock, touchdown, North Dakota State.
Well, football usually comes down to which team's the most physical, and right now that team is NDSU. That was a play that was fairly well defended at the snap, and then the Bison just took over, shoving, pushing guys, and Morlock was not to be denied.
379 rushing yards for North Dakota State, and they are just punishing Southern Illinois on the ground here in the second half. So that gives the Bison a little bit of breathing room. Pearson, good on the extra point again, and that extends the lead to 35-22. North Dakota State's offensive line controlling things here in the second half, and the Bison lead at 35-22 with 9:40 to go.
Timeout on the field.
Explosive plays has been the name of the game for North Dakota State here in the second half. Southern Illinois has a bunch of them, but they have given up a bunch of them too. And so far, North Dakota State taking advantage here in the second
half. Yeah, the Bison turning the table on the team with more explosive plays than anyone else in the conference. Through the pass, you saw that with Urzendowski. Now this long one from King Frazier to bring it all the way down to the 3 after the, or excuse me, this was the touchdown. And now this one takes it down to the 3 after the face mask. So the Bison putting big plays out there on the field and taking advantage of enough of them to have the lead.
That was your Bobcats game recap. And again, LeCompte does what he usually does, and that's put the ball out of the back of the end zone. As you take a look at Chris Kleiman, has to like what he's seen from his offensive line here in the second half. Man, have they controlled things up front.
They're taking over, which is exactly what happened 2 years ago when we were here. Of course, the game wasn't this close, but the Bison in the second half, if you remember that game, it was fairly tight at halftime, and then the Bison controlled it on the ground in the second half and won here in Carbondale.
Still plenty of time, 9:40 to go, and again, the only bad part about scoring this quick is the Bison defense right back out on the field.
Yeah, right after Iannotti had a really nice long drive. They're going for it here.
Billy Reed could not come down with it. C.J. Smith again on the coverage on the deep fade pattern.
Yeah, Reed needs to make this it's not a back shoulder play, but he needs to try to make an adjustment on there. I thought I saw a little bit of a jersey tuck and thought they might call something on C.J. Smith. There's hand fighting, and there's the jersey. I did see what I thought was a little bit. Most of the time they'll call that, even though it probably didn't impact the play much because neither guy had a chance to get the ball.
Iannotti bobbles the snap. Now rolling, and DeSomer could not come up with the catch. Jalen Allison has played well today, comes up with another pass breakup for North Dakota State, and it's 3rd and 10.
Yeah, he got his body in position and then the right hand in there to dig it away because it did look like it was going to be complete there for a second.
So Southern Illinois has found a way recently to convert these 3rd and longs, and they have another one coming up here, 3rd and 10.
Can you keep going to the 3rd and long well and pulling it off? Most of the time, no.
Isom has really not been a factor today in the rushing game. Just 5 carries, 14 yards. Bison rush forward, but drops it off to Isom, who slips one tackle, needs the 35-yard line, still on his feet, but eventually taken down right at the 30 by Jalen Allison. And he comes up 5 yards short and a punting situation for the Salukis.
He got hit enough to where he couldn't get momentum. You saw Champion, you saw DeLucchi, you saw Stump all get a piece of him before Allison was able to keep it from becoming a first down, getting only the 5 yards on the play. He was never able to get his momentum going forward.
Mathewson will hang this one up. C.J. Smith will let it bounce at about the 30-yard line and bounces to the 33, and that's where North Dakota State will have it with 8:49 to go. Can the Rams open more creases and holes for those running backs?
I'm going to answer that with a yes. Certainly seems like NDSU's offensive line has taken control. And a lot of that goes back to what you talked about in the first half, Brian, when you have a defensive line that doesn't get rotated, you know, much at all. So you got the same 3 or 4 guys playing down the whole time. And after a while, you just get worn down a little bit and the offensive line starts opening holes.
194 rushing yards a game. That's what North Dakota State averages. Today they have 379 and they're not done yet. Easton Stick will duck in, cover up the football.
No, I guess not.
And gain 4 yards up to the 37.
I thought I saw a little bit of a pull on the face mask, but we're a long ways away from it. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. That was that play that was successful. That was a play that was successful in the first half, but Morlock was unable to get out in front of the play. In fact, there was just him and 4 different Salukis on that side of the ball. So if that was a halftime adjustment made, that was certainly made well on that play.
And North Dakota State in no rush to get to the line here.
Nope.
And try to eat time off the clock, nursing a 13-point lead.
You're milking that play clock right now.
Bison snap it with 1 on the play clock. Back to the ground. Morlock carrying the pile. He's going to be close to a first down, a yard short up to the 42.
Yeah, Zach Johnson gets a good one here. He's a preseason All-American, dealt with some injuries and all of that, but Johnson was able to pull, get a real good push, sear lead in there.
And 1, North Dakota from their own 42.
And the Bison almost 9 yards per play. Nearly double of SIU.
That's a look at your Bobcats game recap. You got Leonard Guerin. Some of these linebackers have been out there a long time. Marquise Jackson, Brandon Williams, they've made some plays, but they've just been out there so doggone long here in the football game today. 3rd and 1, back to power. And Frazier is going to be close, and I think he's got enough as he gets past the 43.
Yeah, he does. The ball carrier. Needed a yard, got a yard and a half.
And Chase Morlock went to the sidelines and looked to be in a little bit of a pain. We'll take a look at the replay here as Chase runs off. And again, he's been dealing with an ankle.
Virtually all season long, and you can tell you're upset. He wants to be in there. He's helped his team. He's powered into a touchdown, and you know, you think you're starting to get over the ankle, and all of a sudden it looks like it's hanging around. In fact, that was of the his two major injuries, if you want to call them that. That's his ankle was being getting closer than his shoulder was.
Play action. Stick rolls. He's just going to take off with it. Across the 45, gets what he can, maybe 3 yards up to the 47.
Well, if Stick could have got his eyes upfield just a little bit quicker, he would have noticed that Bonnet was wide open there for a while. But again, Stick doesn't want to put the ball in jeopardy either. So if he has any question about it, he's going to run it.
See big Rayshon Golden trying to track him down. And Golden, an interesting story, a senior from South Carolina. He actually, every Monday, volunteers at Boys and Girls Club. His goal is to open up his own Boys and Girls Club upon graduation. Back to the ground game again. Frazier, not much that time. A yard to the 47, 48 maybe.
Well, those last two plays defended well. The quarterback run, and this time the power closed off. Only a gain of one.
This game brought to you in high definition by Speak Volumes. Realizing that one drink isn't always one drink. Log on to speakvolumes.nd.gov for more information.
Well, facing a third and six, and that group right there would love to be still sitting around after this play. That was a look at the defense getting its rest on the Bison sideline.
Easton Stick a little bit late getting into the huddle here, and then see if the Bison maybe just take a timeout as the play clock is already down to five, and they certainly don't show any urgency to get up to the line of scrimmage here.
Coach Kleiman's over there watching it. Count down, there's the timeout.
So NDSU will call for a timeout with 5:14 to go here in the fourth quarter.
North Dakota State, their first of the half, 30 seconds in length.
Let's take a look at our new seed fan cam. The Bison always traveling well. The cowboy hats are out. They're thinking Frisco already. Got a long way to go before that. Of course, we'll be back next week. Western Illinois comes to the Fargo Dome. We'll have that game for you on NBC North Dakota Sports. And then the Bison on the road at Youngstown State, and we will head there to televise that game and bring it back to you as well.
As long as you're on a roll, I might as well tell everyone we'll have the Missouri State game, too. We'll
round out our coverage with the final game of the 2015 season and the regular season with Missouri State on Senior Day. And the Bears struggling mightily under first-year head coach Dave Steckel as he tries to turn that program around as Terry Allen was removed as head coach after the season. As we take a look at our total yards on the Bobcat game recap, boy, oh boy, 532 for North Dakota State, one of their best outputs of the season.
Yeah, that's 531 is what SIU was averaging coming into the game. The Bison have turned the tables on it. Third and six.
Stick will run again, and Easton puts his head down, and he's going to be about 2 yards short of a first down to the 48. But the Bison able to churn out a first down or two and run down the clock to 5 minutes, and I think Southern Illinois will call for their second timeout.
Southern Illinois.
That's probably
their second of the half. 30 seconds in length.
I like the decision there for Coach Lennon because otherwise, what's her 504? Otherwise, you're
please
not getting the ball
the
back
till
almost
506.
What? By the time you kick 4:30, by the time you punt it, return a little bit if you get a chance for it. Yeah, so you're saving a potential, you know, what, two or three plays extra for your offense.
And it's Lukey's had a burn one earlier in the half on some confusion offensively. So they only have one remaining now at this point.
Leather next week.
And there's a
leather head this week.
He's got a little cape as well.
Why wouldn't you?
Should have known.
Can't go with one and not the other.
Look at Eric Perkins, who's had a nice day on special teams for NDSU. Had a long punt return earlier in the game called back because of a flag. Also had a long kickoff return up to the 44 on the last NDSU drive.
Well, he could certainly get this all the way to the end zone, or if you want to put it up in the air. No, we're just going to say take it at the 25.
And Ben LeCompte just wanted to get that one off, did not want to risk a block of any kind, certainly knowing that Southern Illinois has that capability, and Billy Reed will watch it sail out of bounds, and Southern Illinois has to go the length of the field from the 20-yard line.
25.
20. On punts, it's only 20.
You're right. I'm wrong.
Iannotti will come back out. Mark Iannotti, 21 of 37 for 228 yards and a touchdown today. And as you said, some of those completions have not been easy, LT.
Well, triple stack to the bottom, double stack to the high side, and a quarterback run.
Iannotti will run with it, drag down at about the 25-yard line. Getting in there to make the stop was one of the backup defensive linemen. That may have been
Mesner.
Bryce Mesner has not played a lot. A former walk-on from Mandan, North Dakota. Iannotti to throw again across the middle. Feeney's got it. Enough for a first down. Taken down by MJ Stump up to the 31.
Little tight end cross. Feeney gets the first down. He was probably hoping to get out of bounds, but he was cut down at the 31.
Chain set. Clock running. 4:30.
Yep, same exact look.
And Prakis stopped after a short gain of one up to the 32, and the Bison did a nice job in the second half of shutting that down.
Well, Pierre G. Tucker right there just blew through the guy who was trying to block him. He just out-muscled him. He said, at the point of attack, you're not going to get me. I'm going to influence this play physically as much as I can, and allowed only the two-yard gain.
Iannotti to throw again. Steps up in the pocket, dumps it off to Isom, and Isom's still on his feet. Boy, is he shaking tackles. And Isom is still going, finally dragged down in midfield. The true freshman showing good strength, only 175 pounds, but boy, shaking off tackles there on that reception.
Well, one NDSU player still comes up and is not up yet, but he's a guy that just, if you're the Bison, he scares you every time he touches the ball. Oh, is that?
That might be an Ambrosius.
Ambrosius got his leg kind of twisted maybe a little bit.
And Ambrosius still down on the field as he twisted Isom to the ground.
Well, the defensive player, you know, injury is a good situation for the offense in terms of just being able to settle down and go out and talk about things.
And they're going to help Ambrosius up, hoping he can maybe walk that off. It's his knee, certainly, that's bugging him. And as soon as he is off the field, the clock will start.
But Ambrosius has that leg kind of pinned under him when he's trying to spin down. See that left leg, how it's already tucked under himself? Man, he's, with those defensive ends, have played a lot of snaps from some guys today that we didn't know if they were able to go. By and large, they've gutted it out pretty well.
Under 4 minutes to go. Iannotti will throw again. Across the middle, Feeney hit hard there by Jordan Champion for a gain of about four up to the 45. Second and six coming up.
Now you have Butler and Jordheim in at the defensive end.
Iannotti will run. Bison all over that. Iannotti still on his feet, taken down after a gain of three up to the 33.
I just mentioned Caleb Butler. He was in on that tackle. Stumpf was the one that tried to come through there and cut him down for maybe a loss on the play. But Iannotti was able to get through MJ Stumpf and then get a couple of yards. But it is third down.
Third and four coming up here for SIU. Iannotti completes it to Feeney. He's going to be very close to a first down, but I think he's going to be a little bit short.
Yeah, he's short by a good yard. But that's been the play so far in this drive, just the quarterback, or excuse me, the tight end drag. You see big number 87 coming across the middle.
Robbie Grimsley, pretty good coverage, the true freshman from Hutchinson, Minnesota. Big fourth down. SIU has to have it to keep the game alive. And Iannotti's just going to run. And he falls ahead for a first down up to the 38-yard line. SIU, one timeout remaining.
Well, somewhere, wouldn't you think you have to take a shot through the air? Press coverage of Smith high side, but safety help, obviously. Too deep shell for the Bison.
Iannotti's going to run with it again. And he's going to be short by a good yard on the first down, so that keeps the clock running.
That's why it's very important. The clock will continue to tick. Well, they stopped it. I don't know why, but they got to crank it now. I don't know why they stopped it.
Now it's cranked up again. 220, 219. Jet sweep. And again, it's Jimmy Jones inside the 25 to the 24 for a first down.
Scored a touchdown on a play similar to that in the first half.
And now Jones comes up limping off the field. So Josh Sullivan checks in. Billy Reed comes off as well. And again, the clock's still running now at 2:09.
DeLuca with the nice tackle. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. But it was a first.
Iannotti going to throw the deep fade. And it is out of bounds and incomplete. Sullivan, the intended target. Jalen Allison in on the coverage. That ball a little bit too deep and a little bit too far out of bounds.
Isolation on it. Allison's been pretty good one man-on-man coverage. You saw him with his hands down low. He knows he's got to pull those back so you don't get the call against you.
Second and 10 coming up from the 24.
You figured the Salukis had to take a shot sometime, though, Brian. And actually, they waited about a minute and a half longer than I thought they were going to try to get the ball downfield. Isolation plays on the outside have been the MO.
Iannotti, open receivers, Lamprakis inside the 10, down to the 7-yard line. Well designed and executed there by SIU, and the tackle made by Grimsley.
Yeah, Bison in the zone, finds a soft spot. Safety can't get over there in enough early enough. It's just a good throw.
Now under 150 left. DeSomer in motion. DeSomer gets the carry. DeSomer taken down at the 5-yard line. And the clock continues to run now under 140.
Boy, DeLuca again comes up with the tackle.
Boy, he has been all over the football field today.
You fool him rarely. His first read is usually spot on.
Dumped off in the flat. Oh, nice open field tackle on the play by NJ Stumpf on Isom. And the clock continues to run. I thought, is that a timeout being taken by SIU?
Timeout, Southern Illinois.
Well, a little pass in the flat last week ended up in a 75-yard touchdown. This time you're only, you're trying to get, you know, into the end zone, and Stumpf just took care of Isom. We saw today what Isom can do once he gets squared up and starts heading upfield. He's got, you know, outstanding feet and tough to bring down. But if you can get to him before that happens, as Stumpf did there, there's no chance for the freshman to make a play.
How about Nick DeLuca? 20 tackles today for North Dakota State. Robbie Grimsley with 10, but a whole bunch of guys have been in to make a bunch of stops for the Bison today. But DeLuca really leading the way.
Well, you come to expect that out of NDSU middle linebackers. You know, obviously the Bison have had some really good ones. I mean, you know, you go back to Joe Mays, you know, and then work back from Mays to now, and everyone in between has been very, very good.
Carlton Littlejohn, Grant Olson certainly played so well for so long. Preston Evans was a middle linebacker.
But by keeping SIU out, you burned the last time out. You took another, 40-some seconds off the clock.
Third and goal at the 4. Iannotti might take off with it. Iannotti taken down at the 2-yard line. So fourth down coming up, and the clock continues to run now as we tick down towards a minute to go.
Andrew Smith comes up with the big tackle to force the fourth down. Can't stop the clock now. Watch number 28 makes his read, comes hard, takes the legs out.
Got to have a touchdown here if you're SIU. Iannotti's going to run with it. And Iannotti is in for an SIU touchdown. 44 seconds remaining, and we're not done yet.
Well, Iannotti gives his team the chance by busting through. That time he was able to bounce off the tackle, keep his momentum going, and get in and get the 6 points that the Salukis desperately needed. That was just a solid finish on a hard run. But the fact, again, that the Bison force that into a fourth down could prove to be big.
Austin Johnson on to add the extra point.
Could prove to be big because of the time it took to get the touchdown.
And Johnson boots it through. And SIU trailing by six, 35-29 with 44 seconds to go. And we'll have an onside kick coming up. The hands team will be on for NDSU.
One of the most unpredictable plays in football, the onside kick.
You just never know
what
can happen. And that guy has been in too many of these the last few weeks. Beth Houle on the sidelines for us has a PetroServe USA sideline report. Beth.
Hey, guys, that Chase Morlock taped up here on the sideline. He's been running up and down the entire Saluki drive there. He seems ready to go. He's got his helmet on. He certainly wants to give it a go. Whether the coaches call his number, we'll wait and see.
Well, the reality is, thank you so much, Beth, that if the Bison recover, they can take a knee and call it good here today. I think the hope is, can you get Chase Morlock back and healthy enough and ready to roll for next week against Western Illinois? He is out there on special teams.
He's one of the members of the hands team. So Morlock is out there. DeLuca, Moody, Stumpf, Bonnet. Ilias.
Chris Adams is the kickoff specialist for SIU. Johnson kicks the field goals. Adams the kickoff. So this is a play if North Dakota State could cover up. We'll win the football game. And now a timeout taken by North Dakota
State. North Dakota State, their second of the half.
Looking at the alignment.
30 seconds in length.
You see Chase Allen out there for Southern Illinois, along with a host of others that play offense and defense. And then, yeah, that even includes some of the other defenders that we see. Kenny James out there, Anthony Thompson, and Ryan Neal.
Yep. Don't think that every player on the kicking team is trying to go for the ball. There are designed players whose job it is to get in there and take people away, meaning get there first, try to clear some space for your team to come up behind you. So there's guys out there whose job it is to try to hit the hands team and to create that ball and maybe get an extra bounce or two. And, of course, you have to spy the kicker, too. You need one player to make sure the kicker just doesn't pooch at 10 yards and try to follow it up. Stumpf is the man closest to the kicker on the high side.
Southern Illinois has lost four games by a total of 8 points this year.
And one Bison player is standing back inside the 40. So, again, that's the other thing you got to look for, too, in case you try to drop it up and over.
Adams.
He's coming near.
Taken by Zach Fron, he's got it. And North Dakota State will retain possession and they are a knee away from winning the football game.
Well, you saw it executed well from NDSU, just what I was talking about. From the kicking standpoint, same on the defensive standpoint. Not everybody on that out there is designed to get to the ball. They're designed to clear people away in order for it to go to your second level guy. This time it bounces right to Vra, one of the guys with the best hands on the team. See how clean Vra has his path to the football. Well done by the Bison.
And that ball never really took that big second hop, LT, to get up in the air real high. Well, a win is a win if you're North Dakota State, especially on the road. Nothing easy in the Missouri Valley. But the ground game was so dominant today, 398 rushing yards.
Well, and the big devastating plays that NDSU was able to put on, you know, through that ground game. We saw, you know, on those that highlight package a little bit ago, King Frazier with those long runs. I mean, it was not only dominant physically up front, but gaining those huge chunks of yards. So the Bison, yeah, you'll take that. Any win's a good win, and this is a good win.
So North Dakota State will move to 6-2 overall. 4-1 in the Missouri Valley and return home to take on Western Illinois next week. And for Southern Illinois, yet another close loss, but their first home loss of the season. They had won 8 of their previous 10 before today's game, and now the Salukis at 3-5 will try to finish up strong here in November.
Yeah, you really like to play from NDSU standpoint of the offensive line in the second half. I mean, that's That's where the game on the offense made the difference. Those Bison up front cleared the holes, cleared the path, cleared the way, got it done physically, and usually the team that's more physical wins.
Beth Houle will try to catch a word with Chris Kleiman, the head coach. And Beth is now standing by with head coach Chris Kleiman of North Dakota State, who's victorious as team moves to 6-2.
All right, coach, improved to 4-1, a hard-fought battle here. What was that sideline like? How hard did your team work together?
Oh, that was a great team win. Offense, defense, special teams. It was this is a very tough environment to win. That's a great offense we played. They did a bunch of things different to us on defense. Hats off to our entire football team. To go back-to-back road games and get them both is a big deal for us.
Now you get to go home. How excited are you to see the Fargo Dome?
I'm excited to see my family first, but no, we're excited to get back home. And our guys have earned these two road wins, Beth.
Certainly. Thanks so much for your time, Coach. Shanley playing tomorrow, or playing today. He's looking to catch up with his son, of course, and find out how they did. Guys, back to you.
Thank you so much, Beth. We'll be back to Carbondale to wrap things up, having your American Family Insurance hit of the game and your Nodag Mutual Insurance player of the game. That's coming up. You're watching NBC North Dakota Sports. North Dakota State really racked up the yards on the ground in this game against Southern Illinois, running for 397 yards. A big cog in that wheel was King Frazier, who averaged 11 yards a carry here today, and he's our Nodag Mutual Insurance player of the game.
How can it not be? 11.1 yards a carry for King. He only ran the ball 16 times to get those 177 yards. Of course, this was his lone touchdown. He also had a 51-yarder. But, yeah, look at some of the holes that he had to run through. That was a thing of beauty by the offensive line right there. That set up a touchdown. That was the replay on the touchdown. But, yeah, that was a power play up the middle, busted from the outside. Yeah, over 11 yards per carry. Pretty easy pick for player of the game.
King Frazier, 11 carries for 177 yards. 16 carries for 177 yards for King Frazier, 11 yards a carry. He's your Nodag Mutual Insurance player of the game. We'll be back to wrap things up coming up after this. Our American Family Insurance DJ Culture Agency hit of the game comes from MJ Stumpf, who laid out Israel Lamprakis here.
Anytime as a defender you can get the top half of the opponent going backwards and his feet flying out, the D-cleater, yeah, that's what you dream of. And MJ Stumpf comes up with our hit of the game.
5 solo tackles, 7 overall for MJ Stumpf. As we take a look at our final stats brought to you by the North Dakota Certified Seed Producers, and when you look and our final stats, I mean, really what stands out, obviously, are the rushing yards. But the time of possession, SIU had the ball a little more there in the fourth quarter to make it interesting. But the Bison did a nice job of bottling up the SIU running game today, LT.
Well, they certainly did. I think any time you have the team that had, you know, was through 398 yards, averaging 531, so you held them that many less than normal. And, of course, when you score fast, you're giving up time of possession. But, yeah, that total yardage right there was just a gorgeous job by NDSU in that ground game to have almost 400 yards rushing. Yeah, that's dynamite stuff. We talked about the offensive line. I'll tip my hat to them once more before we sign off here. But it was a physical overtaking in the second half by the offensive line that helped create all those yards and create the win.
35-29 your final from Carbondale. North Dakota State 4-1 in the Valley and 6-2 overall. Southern Illinois drops to 3-5 and will look to rebound on the road at South Dakota next week. Thanks so much for tuning in. Brian Shawn, Lee Timmerman, and Beth Houle saying so long from Carbondale at Saluki Stadium. Bison win at 35-29. Have a great evening, everybody. We'll see you next weekend when Western Illinois comes to Fargo